Good morning, homies. I'm meant to get in the first. Henry,
looking to upgrade.
Good morning, Archangel. Good morning. How you homies doing this morning? Happy Wednesday. LJ, good morning. Get that character upgrade, baby. Time. Doesn't matter if you show up every day, once a week, once a month, or once a year. We'll always be here when you come back, homie. Excellent. What's going on, everybody? How are you doing? Happy whatever day today is. It's certainly a day, that's for sure. Let's come on. Oop, this one. Bam! We're having a cookies comfy coffee. We can actually probably do this instead. As we're not just chatting. We are in fact, playing the award-winning, story-driven, critically acclaimed, perfectly produced, and immaculately developed Final Fantasy XIV Online: A Realm Reborn. But part of that is we're just kind of vibing, eh? We got, what's it called? EPW Flux in a little bit, but I'm already up and at it and doing stuff today, so I figured we can hang out, get the homies warmed up this morning on this fine Wednesday morning, get that vibe check in, see how everybody's doing. And then once more of the homies are awake in here, we can move on over to the wrestling. Just got a new phone for a little over 100 the other day, plus my new Xbox. Let's go! Hell yeah, what kind of phone did you get? I'm a Google phone stan. I got Google 5, fucking love that shit. The Pixel baby, ooh, gorgeous. Lurking, getting little man's birthday stuff together. Let's go, P Junior. PJ Junior? Junior J? What do we call the little Majin? But happy birthday to the little BJ.
Yeah.
Forrest, good morning. How are you, you beautiful biscuit? So good to see you. Motorola Razr. Oh my god, a fucking classic. Holy shit. Like, wait, do they make new Razrs? Or are we talking the flip phone from like 2008? Because that thing, oh my god, was immaculate. They make new razors? Oh, fuck. And it flips. Oh. Oh my god. We've come full circle. We've come full circle. Holy cow, that's incredible. I had no idea that those were back. That's awesome. Thanks for the 69420 Gil. Thank you for your balls, Zomendi. It's a folding phone like the Galaxy. I didn't really know that folding phones were a thing again anymore, being honest. What is old is new again, and what is dead may never die. True. A smoke time for us. Just for you, baby. Look at that smoke time in there. And for those of you who aren't into the smoke time, we do have a command soft reset, which will be taking over the smoke time command. As soon as we get the emote made for it, the hardest thing with the soft reset emote, and it's something I would very much appreciate, like, the creative juices from all of you homies on, is what the fuck do we make the soft reset emote look like? It's probably gonna be an animated one, right? So, for those of you unfamiliar with the term soft reset in general, what a soft reset is, It's usually used in shiny hunting and Pokemon, but also in like speedrunning and stuff like that, primarily for Nintendo consoles. There is a combination of button inputs you can do that resets the game without having to reset the console itself. So it saves you several seconds. So now I'm wrapped in a blanket. We already got a comfy emote. We just got this chaotic. Check this out. This is me wrapped in a blanket. But this is more to get the vibe, like encompass that idea of like pause, or maybe that's what it could be. It could be like a button, like a VCR button that has pause on it and you hit that, or maybe like just a button that says reset on something and you hit that. But it's to fit that vibe of the mental health check, the self mental health check. Take a moment and just see, how are you feeling? Are you doing okay? Are you feeling anxious? Are you feeling excited? Or anything in between, right? And if you're like, hey, like I'm feeling some kind of way, maybe I need a cup of tea, maybe I need a cup of coffee, a snack perhaps, even some water. And then we'll probably get like a sound attributed to it as well, or like linked to it for a trigger fire. A brain with the pause symbol on it then? I was thinking about that, but we've also got this one, which is like a brain with a plus symbol on it. And the mental health emo doesn't get a whole lot of use. So I want something that fits the vibe, but is also one that people will like using. I don't think I ever actually smoke time for Boris either. Boris, how's your day going, baby? Teddy Ursa? That could work for the message you're trying to relay. Meditating cookie? Cup of tea or coffee? Yeah. Chibi? Lamenti, it hurts my soul to see you spell chibi like that. Oh my god. Where am I? What am I doing? We're just casually mining, so don't mind what's happening on screen. I'm literally just gathering resources, baby. But we're gonna have like that mental health talk. Last night, oh my god, I went to bed at like 9:45 is when I literally went to my bedroom to lay down. And I normally throw something on the TV from my phone via Chromecast. Like, I watch, like, I'll fall asleep watching a documentary usually or something like that. Like, educational stuff is very comforting to me. Am I? Where the hell is this shit? It says it should be here. But I ended up throwing on a Dr. K video from Healthy Gamer GG. And it was in my recommendeds, and I was unable to resist the video. It was, are you an ADH doomer? And I was like, well, I 100% know I'm an ADH doomer, right? So what does Dr. K have to say about that? I'm curious, because I, for the most part, agree with a lot of the things he says. We do disagree on some things, which is good and healthy to disagree on things, especially mental health. But wow, he just expounded, put out into the world during this stream so much information on ADHD that me, who is 31 years old and has suffered with it for most of my life, if not all of my life, just didn't know about. Like, I've existed with this disability for 3 decades. And there was so much stuff I learned last night. So I went to bed at 9:45. I didn't get to bed until 1 in the morning. Fucking, I watched the thing, and then I was just up. I came over to my computer because I shut off my computer, and I opened up my therapy notes, and I was just typing away. And I pulled up the video, and I was like skipping through the video to parts of interest. And I was like, I gotta talk about this with my therapist. My therapy's tomorrow this week instead of today, which is why we're live today. But I was just like, all right, we gotta, the big thing, I was talking about this with my wife last night. So like, I am diagnosed with a number of Conditions: complex post-traumatic stress disorder, generalized anxiety disorder, ADHD, I'm on the autism spectrum, and I have depression. The complicated things with all these diagnoses is that, and with mental health diagnoses in general, is that there is so much overlap between those things. Not so much the CPTSD, that's kind of on its own on the side, for the most part, at least for me specifically. But the depression, the ADHD, the autism, and the anxiety. Lots and lots and lots of overlap. So I'm going to talk with my therapist tomorrow and be like, hey, what we've been doing the past couple years, like, there's still some things that I'm very much struggling with. There's some things we've done really, really good with that we did, were well surpassed my expectations for treatment on these couple of struggles that I've had. But there's some that we've made very little or no progress on. And from the Dr. K video I was watching, he was talking about how these overlapping things like can cause misdiagnoses or an erroneous focus on a different diagnosis when the main culprit is the ADHD. And he's like, if you are an individual, right? Any just person, and you have depression, not you're diagnosed with depression, like you just straight up have depression, you have a 3% chance of in your life developing ADHD. Very, very small per chance. If you're not somebody who has ADHD, but you do have depression, that you will later develop ADHD. However, in individuals that have ADHD, there is a 75% chance that you will later in life or at any point in your life develop depression. So it's way, way, way more likely that if you already have ADHD, you're going to become depressed. Then if you are depressed, you're nowhere near as likely to develop ADHD. And I think that something else that he was talking about and that I was like misunderstanding about ADHD, like I always thought that the term ADHD was a bit of a misnomer, especially with how like the public perceives it and how many misdiagnoses and incorrect diagnoses there are. Like ADHD, if you're not familiar, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. So what it makes people think of is you cannot pay attention, hence the attention deficit. You have a deficit in being able to pay attention, and then a hyperactivity, so you're bouncing off the walls and you can't sit still. When in actuality, there's a word that's missing in that first AD part. And it's regulation. ADHD is an attention regulation disorder. And like just hearing that and hearing him explain it was very like mind-blowing sort of experience. So it's not that an individual can't focus or can't have the attention or anything like that. It's that they literally physically, based on like the development of our brain, I don't remember the parts, and we can watch the video on a Mental Health Monday next week. I've already saved it. But it's, we physically cannot regulate our ability to focus our attention on certain things. So we'll bounce back and forth between being like hyper-focused on something or overloaded by sensors. And that was like just a revelation for myself, because a lot of the things that I get especially anxious about, like in social situations or like being in public and my agoraphobia and stuff like that, is hyperfixation on certain things. Like, where are the exits? Is any given individual like packing heat? Do they seem dangerous? Are they behaving suspiciously? Etc., etc. And that's ADHD. That's not anxiety. That's ADHD. And the ADHD is then causing the anxiety. So it could be that I've just been on, like, Zoloft has been working for panic and stuff like that, right? But it could just be that I'm on the wrong medication, and instead of needing an anti-anxiety medication, I need an anti, or not an anti, but an ADHD, like a regulation medication. V-Cool, good morning, what's going on? So I'm very excited about that. Again, up until 1 in the morning, writing therapy notes about this video, because it was so beneficial to me. So sorry for that. It is the cookie comfy coffee hour, and we are a mental health forward stream here. Is that still Ritalin? There's a bunch of them. There's Ritalin, there's Adderall, who knows what, like, when I was a kid, there were two. It was Ritalin and Adderall. And having been on both of them when I was very young, I mean, all I could remember is having a distaste for it of some kind. I can't remember being so far removed from the experience exactly what I didn't like about it or how it made me feel, because it was so long ago. But yeah, that's something I'm gonna find out tomorrow. Adderall is mega abused by people nowadays too. Yeah, and that's why I'm kind of... That's the big reason I have against those kind of things, is how, like, habit-forming they are. Like, they're amphetamines, baby! And I don't know how I feel about just taking daily amphetamines. But we'll see. We'll see. It's... Like, this is the first step, potentially, of a potentially long journey. It might not even be a first step. It could be that, like, my therapist has, insights that are counter to this that I am not aware of, but this is just like the light bulb flicked and it's like, all right, we got to talk about this and figure out, like, if this is a thing. If it is, where do we go from here? If it's not, then cool. And we continue as we are. Pork chops and fried eggs. That's a yummy breakfast. Hell yeah. Are the pork chops seasoned in any particular way? My favorite way to season pork chop chef moves is some good old-fashioned Tony Shasheries, baby. Just sprinkle the Tony Shasheries on there, get a little bit of butter and like a cast iron skillet, fucking slap that thing on there, bam. Oh, started working at a Thai restaurant yesterday. Hell yeah. I won't be able to watch your morning streams anymore, more than the first 30 minutes. That's okay, V-Cool. We will have the VODs up. I'm trying to be better at getting them up in a timely fashion. They should be up today. They've been pending since this morning. So they should be up today. The past couple that we've had. But how are you liking it so far, V-Cool? How's it treating you? Also, do you get free food? I took Adderall. It was horrible. I mean, I believe it. Like, I remember not liking it as a kid. But also, a big thing about medications, is that your mileage may vary, and they may vary widely. Like, I'm somebody, right, who's actively on Zoloft, and Zoloft works very, very well for me, for my anxiety and my depression. But I have legit heard nothing, but terrible things about Zoloft. Nobody has ever, that I've ever spoken to about being on Zoloft has had a positive thing to say about it. But for me, like, aside from if I'm accidentally going through, like, SSRI withdrawal because I forgot to take it for a week, I got no side effects from it. It's not making me gain weight. I'm able to sleep just fine. The biggest side effect, maybe the only side effect I think that I'm conscious of, is I get some fucked up nightmares, but that's about it. Blazomania, get a plate. Old Bay, ooh, Old Bay, that's a classic too. Like working with anxiety and added paranoia. Oh, interesting. No, but I have a 15% reduction. Nice, there you go. You fix potatoes dresser. What was wrong with the dresser? Luckily, they figured out Celexa and Wellbutrin was the solution to my anxiety and depression. Wellbutrin is one that a lot of people are on, and I have heard good things about. I haven't heard of Celexa, though. I'm missing the third note, and I don't know where it is. There it is. So it's bam, bam. It's like a triangle. All right. Yeah, the medication thing is weird. I got prescribed oxycodone after my surgery a few weeks ago, and everyone was like super worried. I took one when the pain got bad, and I was like, eh? the thing with Oxy and anything like that isn't so much that it's necessarily good at what it does, is that you form that physical dependency on it. So your body cannot function, which is why opioid addiction is such a big deal. Because, like, people can take it once and form that physical dependency, and it can be very problematic, of course. There were whole wars fought over opium for this reason. Only side effect I've had with Wellbutrin was decrease in appetite. Man, I wish I had that. Oh, that's another thing I fucking found out recently. My goodness. Is the, like, rock solid, like, diamond hard link between ADHD and obesity. Because for people with ADHD, again, not all, but very often, if you have ADHD, you are going to have a higher risk of obesity because of the way our dopaminergic circuitry works. So for people with ADHD, we don't get a say in this, but our ability to, like, benefit from a long-term positive outcome is incredibly diminished. So if we aren't getting an immediate action, like reward or consequence, this is important because a lot of people think of instant gratification as literally just that, as gratification. But gratification can be both positive and negative. For somebody with ADHD, like the example that Dr. K gave in the video was like homework. They struggle with homework because there's no immediate input on if the homework is correct or not. The same thing with like practicing musical instruments or any sort of long-term life skill. Giving up something after not immediately being good at it, right, is a classic ADHD symptom. Good morning, Eagles. How are you doing? We're talking mental health. We're talking ADHD, baby. And eating is something that has a significant effect on your dopaminergic system, especially so if you have ADHD, because those dopamine hits are so much harder to get and so farther and fewer in between. So if you eat food, you get dopamine, the happy drug, which you don't get from doing other things that have like a longer term payoff, like exercising. However, our habit forming circuitry is completely unaffected. People with ADHD, if you can get them to form a habit, will be able to form the habit and it'll stick as rock solidly as a neurotypical person. The problem is it's like 90% harder to form the habit because of this instant gratification problem with ADHD. So if I work out for a day and there's no immediate input that was the right thing to do, or you feel worse afterwards, it's a lot harder to go back and do it the second day, even if I know for doing it 2 months, it'll benefit me in the long term, because it's like, well, this isn't working. And it's not something we have any choice or ability to combat, really. And it takes other people helping us, like a gym buddy or a life coach or something like that. And that often gets interpreted by neurotypicals as laziness. It's like, oh, you just need to put in more effort. When in actuality, you're putting in more effort into something than they are, but you have a physical impediment stopping you from being able to do what it is that they're doing. So absolutely, like, wild, wild amount of information I absorbed last night about my own condition that I didn't even know about. But yeah, so for me, when it comes to eating, I physically do not feel full like other people feel full, because for me, eating isn't about the nourishment or the nutrition. And this is not something I was conscious of until literally like this week. So when I eat, it's because eating for me is pleasurable in an emotional way. Eating makes me happy. Eating makes me comfortable. Eating reduces my anxiety, all these other things that have nothing to do with eating for nutritional value. And it doesn't matter how much or how little I eat, my fullness is dependent on how close to baseline I am or how much dopamine is being injected into my system. Like, if I am really, really stressing, I'm going to eat more and more, because each piece of food that I put in my mouth and taste and chew and swallow releases a little bit of dopamine. So you eat and it feels good. You eat and it feels good. You get that positive feedback loop. And that turns off the feedback loop of, hey, this is more food than your body needs, because my body's like, I don't need this for the energy. I need it for the emotion. Very, very cool stuff with the brain. We're gonna start. What time do I have the timestamp for the wrestling this morning? I think it's 10. Yeah, in 44 minutes. So in like half an hour, we'll switch it on over to the wrestling, folks. I gotta start with that cookie coffee comfy hour, though. But yeah, absolutely, man, like, potentially life-changing information I got, which is very exciting. But yeah, how are you all? I just kinda fucking word vomited on you all for half an hour about ADHD, and didn't really interact with y'all for the most part outside of that, and that's part of the ADHD. I was so hyper-focused on talking about everything I learned yesterday. How are you all doing? How has your week been treating you so far? Lahi, let's go. Lahi. I'm the kind of person who will get prescribed antibiotics after a surgery. Oh, fuck. Speaking of which, V-Cool, thank you so much, baby. Check this out. Meds check. It's a meds check time. Do I have my meds on the table? This is... Nope. Speaking of antibiotics, I got some right here, but I don't need any of those anymore. The infection's gone and the root canals are done. So I no longer need to take those antibiotics. I got a million milligrams of Tylenol here, though. Let me go get my meds. As it is, meds check, folks. Meds check. Get your meds in. I gotta take mine this morning, so one moment. Alright, yeah, meds check time. So yeah, literally same, V-Cool. That's part of the reason we put this med check as a channel point redemption, is because I am very easily prone to forget. I can go a week accidentally without taking my meds because I just forgot about it. Oh my god, I've got so much. Okay. 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 This is gonna be miserable to get. Honestly, wondering how product owners are getting to take to me embracing my inner five-year-old asking questions when I have to do validations. Can you elaborate, Chaotic? Like, individually, I know what all of these words, like, mean in English. I don't understand the context, though, so it's leaving me in a place of unable to understand what you're saying. I apologize. I can't believe how much of that fucking shit we mined. I only wanted a little bit, and we were there for literally just half an hour going in a circle. To rephrase my question, what do you mean specifically by embracing your five-year-old and asking questions when you have validations? When you have to do validations, excuse me. That's where the disconnect is here. Like, I'm understanding you're talking to product owners and you have to ask some questions, but what makes the questions like five-year-old adjacent questions? What am I doing? I've already forgotten. I think I need to be Google Smith. Yes. That's awkward. Oh, fuck. I had precise that shit. Well, we're gonna hit this bad boy and hope it's enough. Nice. Have you been questioned by a five-year-old saying why? Oh, yeah, I was. I was that five-year-old. Hell yeah. Oh my god, I need more wind crystals. I'm about to drop a million gil on fucking wind crystals, and that feels so bad. I'm so sick of mining them. Hold on. How many do I need for that, actually? It's 8 per. Oh my god, I would need thousands of these to do what I want to do. How much are wind crystals? 61 apiece. Alright, let me see here. Let me go to my miner. So this 180-second cooldown gives you about 25-ish per hit. So 100 every 3 minutes, plus 4 every node in between that. So 4 times 5, so that's 20 per node versus 100 per node. So you get roughly 20 wind crystals per node. So let's say we want 5,000 crystals divided by 20. That'd be 250 nodes. You know, it's actually not terrible. We can do that. Not right now, but we can do that. How do we get crystals? Mining. Or probably gathering. These bad boys. What the fuck? Oh, search by gathering method. Yeah, mining and logging, harvesting. Mining and botany. I could hang an Ultima Thule. Not a bad place. My free company chest is full of crystals. I have never even looked in the free company chest. That is so intimidating to me. Hell no. All right, however, let's just say in the past when I was doing analytics, I stepped on a few toes when it came to benefit numbers they were presenting, and I had to verify within reason their numbers. I mean, good job, Chaotic, good job. That's, honestly, if she hasn't already talked to you about it, that is something I think that Cammy would benefit from talking to you about, because that's something that she definitely struggles with at work, is worrying about, or even when she does, stepping on people's toes when it's coming to, like, benefits numbers and stuff like that, or their pay. Because at her place, like, people fudge the numbers a lot. And she always gets really worried that, like, everybody's going to hate her because she's like, guys, I'm a fucking accountant. This is illegal. Like, we have to do this the right way. And they're like, eh. And she's like, brr. But as I'm not in that field, it's really hard for me to do anything other than listen and allow her to vent to me. Because, like, I don't fucking know, man. I think she's doing a great job doing what she's doing. I think that's, like, what she's supposed to do. She's 1,000% doing the right thing. That's what I say. Yeah. But she struggles with it because, like, it's her place of work, right? And these are people she's got to see every day. And gets an attitude with her. She, like, she's worried that, like, they're gonna, like, oust her or something like that for doing her job the right way. Yeah, her immediate boss backs her up a lot of the time, but her boss's boss is usually against the two of them. And in my opinion, like, completely inept at their job. Like, her boss's boss is... I don't know how they got the job that they got, to put it simply. If she ever needs to vent or get support, I know the same thing. Of course, yeah, absolutely, Copley. Hold on, I'm gonna, really quick, folks, I'm gonna put us into this right here, because guess what? It's just about wrestling time. We're gonna get set up for the wrestling. I'm gonna change this, and I'm gonna go to the bathroom real quick. What is it? Enclave Pro Wrestling Deluxe.
Hello there.
WWE 2K24. Bam. We are updated. QLG. Hello there, homie. Just in time. Just in time as we're switching over to wrestling right now. But I do got to run to the bathroom really quick. But Duncan went right through me. This is important. You can tell because it's highlighted. Goddamn, that hair and beard look. Oh, hello, Venti. Thank you so much. One day I will have a beard as glorious and magnificent as yours. But for now, thank you. I really appreciate that. I'll be right back. All right, my friends, it is time for some wrestling flux. I'll catch up on chat in a second. Just let me boot the gamerino up. Got here just in time. Toaster, yes, you did. Hell yeah. Sensed EPW? Excellent. That's probably just gas. It certainly could be. I've had the CMA talk with her a few times. What is CMA? The Country Music Awards? The horrors persist, but so do I. Yeah, exactly. The depression is chronic, but the ass is iconic. Need to go see you guys. Take care. Be cool. Have a good day. 2K is sinking with the clouds. So once it's done sinking. For people who get bullied out of a paper trail in the actual meeting, if no one else is providing meaning in this, you can always create your own. Oh, interesting. Lack of contention serves as verification. Care, though. This works both ways. I take notes at meetings in Notepad, whether I need to or not. Oh, covering my ass. I never would have guessed that in a million bajillion years. Well, I need to connect to this controller really quick. It did. In InfoSec, we CMA often. You sure you want this to happen? Can you email that to me, please? Makes sense. Sure does. All right, I'm gonna get the first match set up here. Then I'll put predictions up, then we'll switch the scenes, baby. No, we're not Saturday morning cartoons, we're Flux, baby. All right, this opening contest is Blue Siren's season 3 debut, and she's taking on the Aurora Lights. Alright, so let me get the predictions up. Blue Siren. Member of the Isle of Queens. Aurora Lights. Is 1 and 2. Get 5 minutes on the clock. Predictions are up. We're gonna spectate this match. It would help if I had the right thingy-majiggy over here. Gotta pull up people's custom entrance music. LJ, if you've got entrance music for Blue Siren, can you please put it in Discord, in the character creator channel, so that I can add it to the, and also, like, the billing, where you want Blue Siren to be hailed from. Right now, the following contest, we'll say she's from Atlantis, is a debut singles match scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, making her way to the ring. From the lost city of Atlantis by way of the Isle of Kings, Blue Siren! Got a haircut, trimmed my beard last night, and now I'm 80% less scruffy. Hell yeah. Was that your high school nickname there, Abby? 80% less scruffy? The difference to be noted between personal notes and published meeting minutes sent to all participants to confirm slash clarify the conversation. I didn't even know that was a thing. Meeting minutes? Wow. I guess I should mention we also record all of our meetings since they're video via Teams slash Zoom. Nice. Never once have I gone back and watched one of those videos, though. Ain't nobody got time for that. True. But if anything ever happens, somebody will go back and look at them. So it's good to have the resource. Predictions are up in this debut singles match. Did I leave my fucking phone in the back? No, I didn't. Hold on. And her opponent, making her way to the ring from the Borealis itself. She's a mama six, so you know she can handle her shit, as well as the Enclave Pro Wrestling Super Prestigious Dark Match Champion, the Aurora Lights. That was a great place to end it, ladies and gentlemen. Place your fucking bets. Scared channel points don't make no channel points. My high school nickname was 20% Scruffy. Hell yeah. I thought Azzy was the dark match champ. Oh, that's a good point. Yeah. She won it. She's double champ now. This probably means that the upgrades from yesterday didn't take. Oh, that's frustrating. We're gonna have to go back and take a look at that. We'll fix this after this match, though. Oh, damn. Thank you for pointing that out, Abby. I never would have realized. Oh, fuck. Well, we're gonna have to take a look and make sure everybody's stats are what they're supposed to be. Irish Whip Blue Siren sends Aurora Lights into the corner here. Aurora gets the elbow up. Goes running. Oh, what a bicycle knee right to the face of Blue Siren. Stomp the back here. Oh, a standing coup de grace. Aurora picking Siren up. Siren getting the upper hand and lands a European uppercut. And Siren, like a fish out of water. One thing to double check that easily would be Duncan's stamina, right? He was maxed out. That's a good point, yeah. What is this? Oh, the inverted Boston Crab here from Blue Siren. Irish Whip. Oh, out of the ring goes Blue Siren. This is a base singles match with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. So they have quite a bit of time out here as Aurora. Oh my god, what is this? Puts Blue Siren in some sort of modified dragon sleeper, but Blue Siren hitting the knees. Why did it take so long for the referee to count one there? Oh, knee to the midsection. Two. This is a very slow count. She simply stole the Dark Match Championship? True. I have the screenshots from mine that she did, so that's another good way to check. All right, excellent. Off the top, big elbow from the Aurora Lights. That's a mother of six right there. You don't mess with that. One. Oh, and a kick out at one from the Blue Siren. Oh, Aurora being like, oh, boo-hoo, you got elbowed in the back. Flipping her over, working that lower back now is Aurora. Aurora pointing down, saying that she's going to make some sushi at a Blue Siren here. Flipping her over and again working the back. Oh my god. Aurora, she must have like gotten into PJ's Monster Energy Stash. Oh my goodness, I think so. That was clearly some sort of monster-induced psychosis. As Blue Siren grabs her by the hair, what is this? Walks her over to the ropes and drops a face right on her cleavage. Like, she changed where that foot was going in midair. It was going to her face, and she's like, nah, I'm getting you in the titties, and then fucking stomped right on her. Blue Siren goes running now, shoulder thrust right through the ropes, and now Blue Siren's standing tall. What we need to check? We need to check everything. Good morning, Ezzy. How are you feeling today, homie? How's the recovery going? Count of two. Blue Siren sends Aurora past the Steel Steps. Doesn't quite land in him. Misses the elbow drop. Can you imagine? Putting the arm down here. Blue Siren looking around. Stomping at the hands. I remember that I was halfway to max spin escape, so we'll see. It's a good... Okay, yes. Good. Oh, Aurora kips up. Almost gets punched in the face, but catches the hand of Blue Siren. Sends her across. Aurora. Oh, man. Did Aurora win that match that she was in over in a LPW yesterday? I was in and out. I was lurking in like four different people's streams. Oh, high-stepping kick. Bam! Right in the back of the head. Also, did Shadow win his match? Prince, as a matter of fact, won his LPW debut. He was against PJ Majin, and like it had to be restarted. There was basically a dusty finish that wasn't. As Prince won by countout, then they were like, all right, we'll restart. And then he won it again. So Prince winning twice in the same night. Double debut win. Blue Siren resetting the count. Doesn't want to win by countout. Nice. I'm good. Just woke up. Excellent. Glad to hear. Shadow got counted out? Hell yeah. Classic Shadow. Going for a pin here. Is the Blue Siren on the Aurora Light? So that's a two count. I think what I need to do is I'm going to write the stats. If it's messed up. Yeah, absolutely. Talthar, I think, has posted in the Discord. I'm not sure exactly where. It might be pinned. If it's not pinned, I'll look for it. Or if one of the mods can look for Talthar's post and pin it. He's got a fillable Google Excel sheet thing. Google sheet. Where you can keep track of your stats individually if you want to. I would definitely recommend it at this point, because 2K is fucked on us incredibly hard. Aurora kick to the midsection. Looking for the Aurora lights out. On to Blue Siren. One, two, three. And Aurora picking up the dub with the Aurora lights out. And to speak, no sooner shall you speak the devil's name than he doth appear. Talthar, what's going on, you beautiful biscuit? Guys, gals, and non-binary pals at home, here is your winner of the match, the Aurora Lights! 50-50 here, Aurora going to 2-2. Oh, it would really help if I had the EPW records up. EPW Championship history. We'll play Aurora's music for the victory, so it's not just awkwardly quiet. All right, in the records over here. Well, actually, no. We got to go back to the menu to see if we got to change it so that Azzy is the Dark Match champion. But before we even do that, we're going to check out stats here. So the first person we were going to look at was Duncan, because he had like either stamina or pin escape, but maxed out. We'll come down here. It is. They're both maxed. Okay. It may just be that the championship didn't save. Who else said that they had their point updated? Their points like from yesterday, so you know exactly what they're working with. Blue Siren goes to 0-1. And Aurora Lights goes to 2-2 on a two-win streak. All right, Prince first and QLG. And then if all three of you are correct, we'll assume that everything is correct. All right, Prince, what did you get points in yesterday? The SS are in the dizzy. Thank you, Talthar, for posting that. Oh, Oh, okay, cool, cool, cool. And I took the screenshots. That's perfect. 88, 76, 43, 67. Okay. Yep. And finally, 40, 73, 72, 60, 40, 64, 77. Okay, Princess is saved. I'm thinking it was just the championship. QLG will check yours real quick too. But yeah, I'm pretty confident in saying that it was probably just the championship then. Forty-nine on Pin Escape. All right, cool. Nice. So, for whatever reason, it didn't like that the championships changed. Pete is the champion for the men's division, though. Yeah, because we had the two dark matches. Did Pete win the dark match championship in the men's side? Wait, what the fuck? It shows that Azzy's the champion. Why did Aurora come out as the champion? So Aurora literally stole the belt just for that match. We should have checked this first. What the fuck? The reason that we're checking this, Azzy, is because when we did that last match, Aurora came out with your dark match belt. And Abby brought it up, like, wait a minute, why is Aurora coming out with the belt? Azzy's the champ. And we're like, oh fuck, maybe the upgrades didn't save if the championship didn't save. But the championship did save, and Aurora just came out with the belt anyway. That's never happened before. That is so inexplicable. Hold on, like, what? That's something. Holy cow. Yeah, for real. This happened in a main show. That wasn't a dark match that she brought that belt out to. Yeah, absolutely go for a promo on that one. Holy cow. I can't believe that. That's crazy. That's just straight up never happened before. All right, hold on. Let me mute this copyrighted music so YouTube doesn't get mad at me when you upload this VOD. I don't like 2K pulling its BS this early. 2K is 2K and very 2K-ly this morning. But folks, if you have not seen, we are having a tournament this entire month to crown a new number one contender for the Enclave Pro Wrestling Intercontinental Championship. The image is posted in Discord, but this is a direct link I'm going to post to the image. It's a .png. It's a big link, but you can just open it and you don't have to open Discord. It just opens the image in your browser. This is what the bracket is looking like. So coming up next is the first match in that bracket, which is Spiral. Excuse me. Taking on Heel Kevin. Do I have music for Heel Kevin? I don't. I won't accidentally get promo material because 2K fucks on us. That's, I think, one of the best things about doing EPW the way we do it is that 2K can just fuck on us and we turn it into a storyline. Good morning, everyone. The following contest is an Intercontinental Championship first round match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring from Death Valley, he is the monster, Spiro!
Does it count if my... Can we swap stats for the tournament? Unfortunately, no. while we can't, unfortunately, straight up pick a winner of the tournament, I tried to put you on what is the easier side of the tournament, Godpod. Because, like, as the booker, I want to see you in an Intercontinental Championship match. But also, I want to have a tournament. The best arc, as anybody can attest to, the best arc of any Shonen Battler is the tournament arc. Look at it, you got your fucking Yu Yu Hakusho, your Hunter Hunter, right? You got your Naruto Chunin exams. You got the DBZ tournament. Any tournament arc is the best tournament arc. You get the fucking, the games in My Hero. What's the FF14? So there's two. There's a part one and a part two, Lamenti. The first one is Answers. It is the main theme to A Realm Reborn. The second one is a spoilery song, so don't listen to the second one, the part two. It's called Your Answer. And his opponent, making his way to the ring from the Florida, Georgia line. He is the CEO of the HWA, the general of the heel Kevin Army, and 2017 Super Bowl winning Philadelphia Eagle, heel Kevin! Lahi? Like the Lahi? That song? That's called Lahi. There's also the Heavensward main theme. Before we get into this match, we're gonna do a quick listen to of four Final Fantasy XIV songs. And you can tell me yes or no if it's the song you're thinking of. It was Lahi? Hell yeah. Lahi? That's from Shadowbringers. Not gonna tell you anything other than that, but that is where it is from. Oh, Spiro starting us out right here. Goes for a punch, but Heel Kevin catches him. Drops him on his face with that suplex face buster. Saw an article that the diamond industry is in trouble because Ladgrove diamonds are taking off. My heart breaks for them. That was my engagement ring. Oh, pull. Okay, yeah, bets. Let me get the bets in. I see number one contender tourney. Spiro. Heel Kevin. I don't know their records off the top of my head, and I want to get these predictions in. Bam! Predictions are up. Godpog, what? My ride is here. I'll see you later. Take it easy, Godpog. Have a great day, homie. Stay safe. Sending you all the luck and love, my dude. Oh, Irish whip. Oh, man. Huge boot from Spiro. Yeah, we straight up, because, like, for us, like, our relationship has always been so close, and we've been together for so long. Like, in our minds, even when we got engaged, we were already married. So, like, all of the pomp and circumstance around, like, a tradition. Oh, Heel Kevin. Oh, my God, a vertebraker onto Spiro already. Is this match over in 90 seconds? One. And a kick out at one. Yeah, for us, like, the pomp and circumstance, like, and the expense around a wedding. The Solo Sikoa? Holy fucking shit, no way. What's going on, homie? Welcome on into EPW. Please don't spike me. Like, I'll raise my one. Yeah, to the bloodline. Solo Sikoa, how are you doing this morning, brother? Good to see you. Welcome into EPW, our mental health forward community, eFed Variety Gaming channel, where we're looking to reduce the stigma surrounding mental health and mental illness. Caught us on a Wednesday for some Tuesday morning flux, or Tuesday evening flux. I don't even know anymore. It's gonna sick Tama Tonga. Oh, hit me with the dirtiest flatliner in the game, baby. Solo, let me tell you, come here. Right, look, like I get you and Oots not on the best terms right now. But how do you trade in the super kick and the Uso splash, right? And the Uso splash for a flatliner, right? I know it pinned LA Knight the other day, right? But it's a flatliner, okay? Nobody is convinced that dealt any damage to anybody. You gotta teach them the spike. Maybe give them a little something else there, you know? But, man, the flatliner ain't it. Emeralds. Lab-grown any gem, pretty cool. Oh, heal Kevin on top. What is this? What? Oh my god, from heal Kevin. Wow, what almost like a moonsault crossbody onto a Spearow. I don't know if Kevin had that kind of athleticism to him. Oh my god. Kind of lose the intimidation factor for me. Like, exactly. Like, y'all, I'm scared of you, Solo. I'm scared of you. Let me say that. I got respect. Don't kill me. But when you got a brother using a flatliner, right? I know he's in the big leagues now. He was across seas for a while. It was over there or whatever. Change it. You know what's a good move? The Blade Runner. Maybe give him that one. I think he needs a devastating submission finisher. Yeah. I agree. Can never go wrong with like a dragon sleeper or something like that. Like Roman had the guillotine. Give him some version of the guillotine right now. Spearow, no! Spearow tried to dive, but he almost landed in the front row of the crowd by missing. Give him the Taz mission. Yeah, give him the Taz mission. That'd be great. Give it some like really baller name. Oh, heal Kevin. What is this? Picking Spearow up. Oh, wow. What a brain buster. But Kevin landed awkwardly on his lumbar spine and Spearow's crawling over to the corner. No pinfall yet. Oh, right hand to the face here. Another right heel, Kevin. These two monstrosities of men absolutely going at it. Oh, my God. These chops to the chest of Spearow. And he goes down. Kevin flips him over for the pin. Is there going to be a rope break? Referee doesn't see the rope break. Spearow's leg was, like, hanging over the apron. Oh, man. Kevin, he's been pretty much all business. Spearow playing a bit of possum there. Oh, big leg drop.
Hello there.
From the undead man. Abby, what's going on? How is the toast toasting today? Spearow going for the choke slam, but Kevin blocks it. Kevin grabbing Spearow. Looking for another brain buster, perhaps. No, just tosses Spearow across the ring. Lots of suplexes from Kevin. Do we got the toaster in action tonight? I know that we're going to have the toaster be the debut opponent for the Crockpot. I'm excited for that. Kevin, what is this? Kick to the midsection, the BFT. Blunt force trauma. 1, 2, 3. Here is your winner of the match and advancing in the Enclave Pro Wrestling Intercontinental Championship Tournament qualifier, heel Kevin! I didn't have time to put the records in the prediction, but this does count for the records. So Kevin, he was 1-1, he goes to 2-1, and he's on a 1-win streak. Spearow goes to 1-4. Is on a 1-loss streak now. Coming up next, what do we got here? Elimination tag. As we have got Church of Chaos. What is the Church of Chaos's overall rate? They're 1-2. That includes the men's, though, huh? I'm gonna put 1-2 in here. But I am gonna go back and, see if that's accurate for the women's side of Church of Chaos, because I didn't have them separated And they are taking on the Isle of Queens.
Hello there.
And the Isle of Queens currently are 3-3. And this is going to get us working towards figuring out who challenges for the women's tag team champion, Slight Pandemonium, at Pandora's Box. Well, provided the women's tag champions maintain being the women's tag champions up until Pandora's Box, what with the wheel and all. Predictions are live now. Hello there! Ayo, what's going on, baby? If it looks like a match is going to run between 11 and 11:30, can we move it earlier? What time is it? Hour and a half. Certainly. I mean, I have it as the main event, so it would be like the last match. Let's see. How much time estimate do I think? 10, 5, 5, 10, 20, 30, 40, maybe an hour from now? Let's see, so 11 to 11:30. We'll put it as the first of the championship matches. So after the debut of Twitch President versus Goblin Queen, we'll start the championship matches with you versus Extengrim. And then we'll have the main event be Goalie versus Jazzy. Kevin! Oh my goodness, of course, bro. And also, I'm both happy and sorry. You missed your match just now, my guy, but you won. You crushed it. We're having an Intercontinental Championship tournament this whole month. You were just in the first match of the first round, and you have advanced. So you're in the second round to crown our number one contender. We got Pandora's Box coming up later on this month. But of course, my friend, great show last night. Fantastic show. John, what's going on, you beautiful biscuit? How are you doing? At Heel Kevin, bam. Folks, if you do not already, you see at the top of your screen how there's a little heart there. You know the cool thing about Twitch? You can follow somebody and it's completely free. And like worst case scenario, right? Let's say you may not be interested in somebody's content that we shout out. Hit the follow button anyway. You can turn off notifications for notifications you don't want to see. But it is so... There's no reason to not follow somebody, right? Help them grow. Help the homies out. They help us out. We help them out. It's that simple. A rising tide, my friends, raises all ships. We all bring each other up. No bringing each other down around here. So if that heart is not lit up, you better go hit that heart. Heel Kevin, of course, the general of the Heel Kevin Army, where everybody eats. And the passion for pro wrestling and video games runs deep. From thrilling horror game nights, and thrilling is definitely an understatement, because Kevin is not, not the most horror, he doesn't vibe with the horror. He gets spooked as much as he takes me for a ride with some of the things he says to me, and I believe he gets taken for a ride by the spooky ghosts. But you can catch him for live reacts every week to Raw, SmackDown, Dino. Do you do NXT too, Kevin? Were you doing NXT? I know there's Dynamite, Raw, and SmackDown. I'm late, but I'm here. Sick, what's going on? Backed up main sewer, so... Oh, Jesus. I am so sorry. Of course, the alarm went off at, like, 11:30 as the wife is in the shower. Oh, no. Hopefully, like, the backing up of that didn't affect the shower. Glad I wasn't asleep yet. It would not have been a fun morning. No kidding. He's great with horror games. The content he makes for horror games is great. That's for sure. I have seen some times though where this man has nearly pissed his pants on stream. No. He might have even. There might have been a little bit of pee-pee that came out there. Who's to say? Fuck that game. Let's go. Hell yeah. John, have you tried out Final Shape yet? And also, how is the new Lorcana set? That came out, what, like last week? The week before? What am I doing? Oh, Church of K. Let me get into this, because Coakley wants to see his match before he goes. So the predictions are up for another 30 seconds. Whoopsie. Custom matches. Elimination base tag. on Flux. Whoop. And we've got the Church of Chaos. Sister Kara. Is she not, like, listed as in the Church of Chaos? Hold on one sec. Let me make sure that they're both in there. Neither one of them are. What happened here? Oh, did we put it as a... No. Interesting. All right, we'll put them both in here. I think what I was going to do was set them as, like, a women's tag, so that way we could have the division separate, but I must have forgotten. So we have got Sister Kara and then Yokai. There we go. Okay. And now they can have their dual entrance. Oh, wait, hold up. Also, Isle of Queens. Let's make sure we put Blue Siren in here. So don't forget that. There we go. Nice. Play. Custom matches. Elimination base tag. This is at Flux. Bam. Yokai. Sister Kara. Taken on. It's Valerie. Valerie. And Destruction Doll. Give me one sec, guys, and I'll check out chat. Sorry, just wanted to make sure I got this all done properly. Look at Destruction Doll's abs. My God, I wish I had abs that good. Jesus. All right, factions, Church of Chaos, get that ready. Oh, God. You should do that when you want to get my attention in chat. Just do that. Mark the game. Nearly? I mean, I don't know. I wasn't there. Like, they're being in the room with you. All right, ladies, gentlemen, theys, thems, guys, gals, and non-binary pals at home, the following contest is an elimination base tag match. There are 20-second ring outs. There is a 25-minute time limit, I think. Either way, last team standing will be declared victorious. Introducing first, making their way to the ring, the team of Sister Yokai and Sister Kara, the Church of Chaos. I think if using nearly with absolutely, tasty. Did you check out the game I suggested? Yup, and fuck you too. I am not. The new Arcana set is pretty good. The big card in this set is another Emerald card with Evasive that when it's tapped, you draw whenever the opponent draws. That's disgusting. That's a card they need to make in Magic. Yes, please. The Killer Clown Survivor's Face game should be out. Yeah, I've seen a couple of people play it. It's interesting. The HWA six-man tags may need some stability. Absolutely. Fuck. I made a joke. Oh, yeah. Fucking Joka and his Juggalo wannabes over there. We're gonna bring some stability to their great value Dark Carnival. Fucking Jossie. Oh my God, the Shawn Michaels music. Yeah, perfect. How can it be said Krabby is the best abs when Didi is right there? Well, because Krabby's abs are better. It's that simple. Whose ass is she carrying to the ring? That's the jar. The Isle of Queens' entrance is broken. All right, and their opponents. We'll play Valerie's music for this, actually. Just because it's really good. And their opponents making their way to the ring. The team of the Destruction Doll and the Viper, Valerie Venom. They are the Isle of Queens. I love this song. Aurora, about to be in there for touching my belt. I thought I said my butt. Oh, Valerie throwing Yokai off. What the hell? Valerie just sending Yokai. How? What? Okay. Valerie taking Yokai by the back of the head. Either Yokai is incredibly light or Valerie is incredibly heavy. I don't know what's going on there, but Yokai is like twice Valerie's size, so. Valerie grabbing Yokai by the back of the head, slams her face first into the turnbuckle. Looking to make a tag immediately. Here we go. In comes the Queen of Spades herself, the Destruction Doll, and gets torpedoed off the top onto Yokai. Oh, both queens. Oh, get thrown onto their back here. Yokai getting up top. What is this? Oh! Destruction Doll says, anything you can do, I can do better. As Yokai goes to make a tag, but is unable to do so. Perhaps we're going to see a Romero special? No, just a double knee smash there from Destruction Doll. Valerie Venom coming back in. Great tag team fundamentals here by the Isle of Queens. You love to see it. Oh, uppercut. Wow, several uppercuts right to the gut. Man, European uppercut. Those were like ovary punches. A couple of right hands here from Valerie. Oh my God, to the face. Like, if they were the same height, those would be like bottom of the rib cage. But that definitely wasn't bottom of the rib cage. That was a bit lower. I may have suggested a horror game called Lunch Lady, but it's multiplayer. So we'll be suffering together. Lunch Lady, that name sounds traumatic. Oh my goodness. Hell yeah. When is this gonna be happening at? I gotta make sure I mark my calendar for that one. I'm about to have 6 kids worth of crayons? What? Like, to eat? Are you going to give birth to 6 kids worth of crayons? What do you mean by have? Are they tasty? What flavor crayons are they? Oh, Sister Kara getting tagged in. First tag here for the Church of Chaos. Sister Kara grabbing Valerie Venom face first. Slams her into that turnbuckle. Oh, right hand. Grapple here, tossing her away. What is Sister Kara doing from the top? What a bulldog! Off the middle rope. And going for a pin here is Sister Kara, hooking the leg. In comes the Destruction Doll, breaking it up at the count of 1. This ref needs to be paid more. PJ, down, boy. Down, somebody get the spray. You'll see in promos, excellent. Oh, man, what an uppercut by Sister Kara. Grapple, putting her down. Oh, what is this? Oh, man, trying to break the arm right out of the socket. My goodness, bonk. PJ, yeah, thank you for the bonk, Infinite. Very needed there, very needed. Going on over to make the tag is Sister Kara. We're gonna see a double tag here. Yokai and Destruction Doll both coming in. Kind of squaring up, big uppercut. What is this? Yokai, man, Yokai's skipping arm day, not able to pick anybody up. Destruction Doll, European uppercut to the back of the head onto Yokai, who's kind of struggling in this matchup. Biggest person in the matchup. Not able to do much of an impact as Sister Kara gets punched right in the face. Speaking of which, I texted Sister Kara today. Did she text me back? Gave her a mental health check. Wanted to see how she's doing. Because she started the new job or the promotion or whatever recently. Nope. I did text her at 8 o'clock. Whoa. Tag is made. Valerie wasn't even looking. Destruction Doll walks up and's like, tag, you're in. Oh! Goodbye, Sister Kara. Yokai gets caught by Destruction Doll, sent into the ring, into the referee even. Even though I'm taller than both of them, but it's okay. Kara's throwing them around, though, so I don't know. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yokai is, like, 7 feet tall, but only 100 pounds, so she counts as, like, a cruiserweight. Oh, wow, what a big pump kick there by Destruction Doll. Yokai makes the leaping tag. Sister Kara squares up, grapple. Oh, what is this? Oh, my God, several punches, and then a right hand flips around. Sister Kara from behind. Look at this. Armbar locked in. Fujiwara armbar is applied. Destruction Doll rolling out of it. Nice mat wrestling. Yokai almost getting disqualified for not leaving the ring. Destruction Doll grabbing Kara, bringing her over to the corners. Slams her face first. Oh, kicks to the ribs here, and a roundhouse kick to the face. My God. Destruction Doll raking that wrapped foot, that wrapped sole across Kara's face, and hits her with the broski boot. For a pin. 1. Oh, Sister Kara kicking out at the count of 1. Not even a 2, baby. Let's go. Kara to her feet. Destruction Doll helping her up. Oh, coochie kick or punch. Crusher. Oh, okay. That was so disrespectful. What was that about, Destruction Doll? Oh my god. Yokai breaking it up. Destruction Doll goes over and thought better of knocking her off the apron. But Destruction Doll looking for a destruction kick. And it connects, taking Sister Kara's head right off. And Yokai just came in, so she can't break this up. One, two, and Sister Kara's gone. Yokai kind of squandering an opportunity and gets blacked out by the Destruction Doll. Here comes Valerie Venom to put it away. Valerie Venom grabbing Yokai. Irish whips her into the ropes, goes low. Grabs Yokai by the back. What is this? Ripcord and a punch to the jaw. Another tag is about to be made here from the Queens. Destruction Doll coming in. Wow, this has been a tag team clinic here from the Isle of Queens. Wow, middle row moonsault. Destruction Doll, where's she going now? Another tag is made. Oh my god, they're just rubbing it in now. The fact that they can make tags and Yokai cannot. Valerie Venom, the Viper. Waiting for Yokai to get to her feet. Oh my god, just a kick to the face. Not even letting Yokai breathe, really. One. And a kick out at one from Yokai. She's not going down yet. Valerie Venom squaring up with Yokai. Kicks him in the back of the head. Goes after the arm. And Valerie just stomping away. Oh my god. Valerie. A tour of the aisle from Valerie Venom. And that's probably going to do it. One. Two. Yokai kicks out of the tour of the aisle. What? Oh my god, look at her digging down deep. That's like that demonic energy. But Valerie is there, hits the Harlem high stepping kick. Oh my god. Destruction Doll is like, all right, you kicked out of one big move. Let's see if you kick out of two. Grabbing her by the hand and again just stomping at her face. My goodness. They're using all the tags Cokes doesn't make. Oh my god. Cokes catching strays. He's not related to anybody in this match. Cokes rolling on into the ring. Catches Destruction Doll. Looking for a suplex of some kind. Oh wow, yeah. Oh, looking for number two. Are we going to see the three amigos? Or I guess the San Nakama here. From Yokai, and then a kip up as well. Oh my god. Oh my god, we're gonna see the demonic people's elbow hitting the ropes. Yokai dropping it. Oh, but Destruction Doll with the absolute no sell of the demonic people's elbow hits her with the Kamigoye, and that one might do it. Destruction Doll stomping at the face of Yokai, hitting the ropes herself, and a punt. Oh my god. Hitting Yokai with the punt. My goodness. Destruction Doll, man, barely breaking a sweat. And Yokai sends her into the ropes. Oh, in the turnbuckle, actually. Yokai fighting out of it. Destruction Doll gets caught by Yokai. What is this? Tejana bomb from Yokai to Destruction Doll. Yokai is, like, showboating a bit, but completely unearned, I think. Hits a right hand on a Destruction Doll. Another right. One more big right will send Destruction Doll to the outside, and she falls down. Yokai sets her sights on Valerie Venom here. A right hand. A grapple. Flips her around. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 shots to Valerie Venom. In comes Destruction Doll. And Destruction Doll kicks, or Yokai kicks Destruction Doll right in the face. This is Yokai's moment. She flips around Yokai from behind. Oh my god, a fact of life from Yokai. Here's the pin. One, two. Oh my god, Yokai. Nearly. Holy cow, that was her moment too. And there's a, oh, but she missed. Destruction Doll gets out of the way. Yokai, what is this? Side headlock. Oh my god, a jab to the throat. The item that hangs off a shirt that tells you how much it costs, a tag. Hey, Prince needs those? Oh my god. Needs or enjoys, true. Valerie comes in to break up the tag, but Yokai's actually putting up a solid fight here. What is this? What the fuck is... What was that by Yokai? I have no idea what just happened. Yokai picks up Destruction Doll! She went to hit the Destruction Kick, but Destruction Doll went underneath! She missed the Move Thief! The Move Thief unsuccessful and Destruction Doll tags out. Needs, yeah, like a cat. Making biscuits. Valerie Venom, I'm gonna put it away. Oh, Yokai, no! Coochie Kick from Yokai! Sends Valerie, no, Valerie with the reversal puts Yokai in the corner! Nobody puts Yokai in the corner except Valerie Venom. Yokai fights out of it, sends Valerie into the corner. Yokai is surviving surprisingly well in this matchup. What a kick to the face from Yokai. Two Valerie Venom going for a pin here. Destruction Doll not coming in. Ref, one, and a kick out at one. Yokai, what is she taking a shit? What is happening here? Okay, what are you doing, bud? What are you doing? Picks Valerie Venom up. Collar and elbow tie up. Irish whip into the corner from Yokai. Oh, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like 20 chops. One more. Oh, I got a punch to the face. So disrespectful. Where is this coming from, Yokai? Another Irish whip. Yokai misses the Yokai effect. Misses a knee as well. My knee! Valerie Venom picks up a Yokai with a reversal! Oh my god, digging down so deep. Valerie Venom with the no-sell. Catches Yokai. Yokai, oh, goes for the flatliner, but gets caught with a judo hip toss! And Valerie Venom striking a pose, being like, don't you dare! Don't you dare! Yokai with a headbutt! Oh my god! And then drop it to her knees saying, praise the Church of Chaos. If Yokai wins this match, I will be amazed. The Isle of Quit, I thought this was going to be a squash, and suddenly Yokai is just in this match. Oh, we're going to see a Kinshasa. Oh my god! Okay. What a big move, but here's Destruction Doll. One, two. What? Destruction Doll missed the breakup! What? Goes to pop Yokai up. Yokai rakes the eyes! Destruction Doll hits the Destruction Kick, but Yokai doesn't even go down! Yokai just eats it, takes it on the chin! Yokai goes into the ropes, Destruction Doll dropping on down. Leapfrog. Oh my god! The DKO! One! Two, three. It took long enough, but what the hell was that? Yokai took a Destruction Kick right on the jaw and didn't even flinch. Oh my goodness. Here are your winners of the match. The team of the Viper, Valerie Venom, and the Destruction Doll. The Isle of Queens. That one got dicey. That one got very dicey for the Isle of Queens there, but they do advance to 4-3. Church of Chaos. Take another L. All right, as we are dangerously close to 11 and nowhere near the main event, we're gonna be moving the World Heavyweight Championship match to now. So the Cokes can see his match. And then the rest of the card will proceed as normal. And this is a Lucha Cage match. As we've got the challenger, the 50 overall extend grip, taking on the champion, Koku. Battle match is on. EPW World Heavyweight Championship. I'm going all in on this one. Adrian, what's going on, baby? How you doing? Predictions are going up for this one. I'm going all in. Lucha Cage, EPW World Heavyweight Championship. Extengrim, who is 2-4. Taking on Cokes, the champion, who is 5-2. Does Extengrim have music? I do not have music for Extengrim. Okay. we'll get 5 minutes on the clock, and I'll pull this up and go all in, baby. How are you doing, Adrian? Let's get a smoke time and a soft reset for Adrian.
Smoke some weed!
Folks, the following contest is our main event, but reallocated due to time for the middle of the card. This is a Lucha Cage match and is for the Enclave Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first the challenger, making his way to the ring. Fuck, I know he's a Gravewalker, but I don't know where he's from because I forgot to pull the booking server. From the shadow of the abyss, he is the Gravewalker, Extengrim! Wake and bait! That was our tag team name for a while there. Something, something. Not Earth, something.
Something. Not Earth, something.
Any chance we could do TV title next, LOL? Do you, I mean, sure. I don't have any problem with this. Let's see if you got some birthday luck in ya, PJ. Also, there, oh, fuck. I gotta go all in on this. I gotta go all in for Cokes. Cokes, in character. If you do not win this match, there will be consequences of some kind. I have no idea what. But there will be consequences for Coakley if he does not win this matchup. It's Mini PJ's birthday, so he's... Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Maybe he's got that, that birthday luck for today to win the match. Oh, hey, ayo, Cokes. That's not Cokes' music, but I see you. And his opponent. It's been a while since we've seen this entrance. Making his way to the ring from Boston, Massachusetts, by way of Integral. He is both one half of the Enclave Pro Wrestling World Tag Team Champions and the Enclave Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion, the Coach Coakley! Oh, there will be consequences. Like, Coke's not allowed to have Duncan for a month? Or is it a consequence that won't really do anything? Like, something along the lines of, maybe not exactly, but not quite, like, straight up disqualified from competing for the World Heavyweight Championship for an allotted amount of time, right? Are the world champion losing to somebody that's 2-4 in a match type that is his own? Like, he's got home field advantage in the Lucha Cage? Maybe put him in matches, like only jobber matches. Did I go all in? I did, okay. Oh, this is for the title? My bad. Yeah, this is for the title. Which is better, 2K24 or 23? And which version won't be getting boring to me so quickly? 24 is definitely better than 23. It's way better. I would say neither of them are quite as good as, like, 2K19. Or even, like, SmackDown versus Raw 2009. Yeah, 2K24 definitely better, I would say, yeah. Yep, there's more match types, more weapon types. They fixed some bugs. There are still some bugs that are there. Universe mode is slightly better. My Rise is slightly better. If he loses, I'll have a question for 2K and questions for Patriot Man. I got it for 3 minutes. 3 minutes of playtime. Not even a return on the bet. I mean, hey, if this is what it should be, 95% chance that Cokes wins. Or at least that the crowd thinks that Cokes is going to win. If Extendgrim can do this, this will be an unheralded and unprecedented event in EPW, as Coakley immediately sends him flying across the ring. This is a Lucha Cage. If you're unfamiliar with what a Lucha Cage is here in Enclave Pro Wrestling, it's a 2 out of 3 falls match. Pinfall or submission only. No knockouts, no escaping of the cage. It has to be pinfall or submission. It has to be done in the ring. You can use the cage as a weapon. The cage is preventing you from leaving. But you gotta win twice. I saw it's on sale on PlayStation. It's only $15 off. Should be 50. You could probably find it for 15 bucks on like CD keys. Coakley, what was that move? Not even a one count though. The referee just kind of watching. A jab. Coakley hits an elbow on Extendgrim. Gets him in the ropes. Irish whips him. Cokes. Dropping down. Up to his feet. Leapfrog. Coakley. Oh, elbow and a just a punch to the face. Jesus. It also is still fairly recent. It only came out like 2 months ago. Going for a pin. And again, Extendgrim kicking out before a count of one. Extendgrim should have been allowed to opt out of this match. It's not fair. No, nope. Cokes with the H-bomb. The wheel put him in this matchup. Ain't nobody got a choice when it comes to the wheel. Except for the fact that Dredd has already won the wheel, so we took him off the wheel because he's already won once. But Extendgrim busted open. He's been bombed in the face. Coakley grabbed him by the throat. Coakley's at home thinking, man, this is what all of my matches should be like. Why is this not the norm? As right now, he is manhandling Extendgrim. Looking like the most upgraded character in EPW that he is. But Extendgrim, the lights go out, teleports behind you. Cold Steel the Hedgehog, nothing personnel, kid. Catches Cokes with an inverted suplex. Oh my goodness. Extendgrim switching the momentum, dropping the elbow right into the inner thigh there. Extendgrim again. Working the hammy of Cokes, working the lower body, trying to chop the tree down. It came out in February, no, it came out in March. So I guess, yeah, 3 months? Cokes, what is this? Back suplex onto Extendgrim in the corner. Should have done a PKO. I'm glad I didn't get picked in the wheel. I mean, never know. The wheel of chaos. Anything can happen in EPW. Cokes, slingshot, Saito suplex. My goodness. Extendgrim, you think he may have used all of the last of his power? Oh, these thumbs. These are the thumbs that won him the captain's match in the dark match yesterday. And he's going for the pin. Oh my God. One. Where's the ref? Two. Three. And the first fall goes to Coakley. Extendgrim might be dead. He is the grave walker, but maybe he's walking back into his own grave right now. Extendgrim's hit like 3 offensive maneuvers. Coke stomps on his back, picks him up, but Extendgrim... Oh, no, Extendgrim doesn't. Coakley, Fisherman Buster, and Extendgrim is dead. The Boston Buster, 1, 2, oh, what a one-sided match. Holy cow. Well, here is your winner of the match, and still Enclave Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Champion, the Coach, Coakley. Has Coach ever had a match that was that one-sided before? Like, wow, holy cow. Well, Coakley does win it, goes to 6-2. Coakley goes to 6-2 on a 4-win streak. Holy cow. That was certainly something. All right, coming up next, television championship match. Say hello to your mother for me. Hey, I'm Mark Wahlberg. False Count Anywhere match at Flux. As we've got the challenger, Dr. Krabby, taking on the current EPW Television Champion, PJ Majin. Yeah!
got your predictions. ECW Television Championship. Dr. Krabby. 1 and 2. Versus PJ Majin. 8 and 4. And the champion. Predictions are up. The following contest is a Falls Count Anywhere match scheduled for one fall and is for the Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Championship. Introducing first the challenger, making his way to the ring. From Quebec City, Quebec, by way of the Bikini Bottoms, he is the best abs in the business. Dr. Krabby! And his opponent, making his way to the ring, from Kansas City, Kansas, by way of the Isle of Kings, he is the All Might and the Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Champion, PJ Majin! Yeah! We're in Iraq for this? That's a new one. I had no. What? Hell yeah! Hold on. This is important for this.
You may have heard these words before, but I'll teach you what they really mean. Go beyond! Plus!
Ultra! PJ spends time creating an entrance with new motion, pyro song, etc. Gets jumped in the title match and then wins it so we never see it. Oh my god. Yeah, imagine. That's what it's all about, folks. The purple belt. The EPW Television Championship.
Daijoubu. Naze. Watashi ga kita.
Start us off with a collar and elbow tie up, but PJ says no, and Dr. Krabby goes low, grabbing PJ by the waist. You know he loves that. And taking it to his face. Grapples him, and PJ still throws him off, and Dr. Krabby was winding up for one. Instead, he eats a clothesline and goes down to the mat. Dropping an elbow. Right on the rib cage. The back of the rib cage. Dr. Krabby goes running, hits a European uppercut. Doesn't get much out of it, though. Grapple here, PJ. What is this? What is. Yeah, gets him up on his shoulder. Oh my god! Puts him from the shoulder and drops him down for a PKO. Never seen that before. The only time in PJ's career he has the heavy advantage is because Dr. Krabby weighs like 90 pounds. Literally everybody will have the. Oh my god, a flatliner onto the chair. The chair just got introduced. And Dr. Krabby hits the flatliner on it. Yeah, everybody will always have the weight advantage over Dr. Krabby. He drops the leg. But Dr. Krabby will always have the heart advantage over everybody else. European uppercut isn't as effective because he's Canadian. That's true. He's only a colony. It'll be like a water Pokemon. Yeah, he doesn't get the stab. No same type attack bonus.
But he does get the double bonus. He does get the stab, like double damage, for using like the sharpshooter, for example. Drops the leg, but not the third leg. That leg drops on its own. What a great taunt from Dr. Krabby, my God. And he is working PJ Majin right now. No, not a Vaporeon. That's not the water Pokemon we're talking about. This is a Vaporeon free zone. We're a Snom family around here. We're wholesome Snom enjoyers. Not a D-Gen Vaporeon whatever's. Dropping the leg like Hogan. One, two. He gets the two. Dr. Krabby dropped the leg and got the two. What about Miltanks? Miltanks are fine. Moomoo Milk is not fine. Moomoo Milk is especially fucked up. Like, Pokemon are even more sentient than regular cows are. That's like fucking magical fucking Pokemon titty milk. Get that out of here. PJ Majin, he's getting very frustrated now. The one for all is turning into the all for one before our very eyes is Dr. Krabby. Hits a Snapmare takedown, drops an elbow right into the back of the skull. Think you're saying fuck you to Eevee peeps? No. Eevee peeps are fine. Jolteon, cool. Flareon, cool. Umbreon, Espeon, Sylveon, Glaceon, Leafeon, all very cool. Vaporeon. Remember that episode where they were thinking about the Magikarp sashimi? I do, yeah. There have been a couple of Magikarp, like, dedicated episodes. What a backbreaker DDT by PJ. Going for a pin here after that one, but Dr. Krabby, he's got the best abs in the business, and he kicks out it too. If a dire hero lived long enough to become the villain, that's true. I wonder what other Pokemon they be in. Probably most of them. Dr. Krabby goes running, hits a right hand onto PJ. Goes for the Irish Whip, but gets reversed, and he trips and falls on his face. Magikarp aren't edible, though? Not according to the anime. Oh, nice armbar DDT turns it into the Fujiwara. Imagine just liking Vaporeon, having all the people call you disgusting names. Because, well, I wouldn't call you a disgusting name. I would just say you are disgusting. And that's a fact of life. One, two, three. Here is your winner of the match. And is still Enclave Pro Wrestling Television Champion, the All Night PJ Majin. Yeah! PJ goes to 9-4. Dr. Krabby goes to 1-3. PJ on a 2-win streak. Of course. You go enjoy your day, PJ. Tell PJ Jr. that all the homies on the internet hope he has an awesome day. We're wishing him all the best. Big happy birthday from the EPW fam to yours. Now where are we at in the regular card? Godpok versus Madman, Intercontinental Championship Tournament, baby. All right, predictions are going up. We have got Madman is 1-2. Oh, caps are reversed. Whoopsie. Godpok 2-2 with Talpa. The following contest is a first round Intercontinental Championship qualifying tournament match, scheduled for one fall
with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making his way to the ring. Where's Madman from? Oh, we don't have where Madman's from. Formerly of the Anarchy Republic, the Madman! Y'all got a duck? PJ trying to slap us with that belt? Hell yeah. Also, Godpac, hello! Prince, you change your name color? No. Never change my name color, so if someone changed it, yeah, same. Test, I should have a similar color, yeah, a slightly darker shade of blue. If this ever changes, if this is anything other than this color, or maybe pink, like the two EPW colors, the light blue and the pink. If it's ever anything different, it's not me. And his opponent, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Talthar of Talthar, Talthar, and Talthar. From Alexandria, Egypt, by way of the Isle of Kings, he is the Nightmare, Godpocalypse! Could be screen brightness change? Could be. Speaking of things looking, how is your eye doing, Godpoc? Has there been any development with that? See, look at this, it all works out. We get to see our match with the Godfox. We see his, yeah. Yeah, fantastic timing, honestly. Bad news on the eye, optician said glasses won't work and I should pray to God that in time it will fix. Like, can you get that in writing? And I don't know how things work across the pond, but like around here, if something like that were to happen, you would either be able to be on like indefinite, some sort of like supplementary workers comp, or you could straight up sue. That you like, you're theoretically permanently injured. Yeah, some sort of big boy settlement, Godpog. Never have to work again a day in your life. Get it on, Godpog and Madman. Godpog throws him off immediately. I thought he was going to hit the Fist of Fate. Instead, hits a big lariat. Grapples with Madman, kicks him right in the dick. Oh my god, what a big move. Going for the pin immediately. Is Madman dead? 1, 2. Almost won immediately. Boston Eye and Ear Institute does some incredible work, if that's ever even remotely an option for you, Godpac. I'm looking to see what's going on with the right eye as well at the moment, then looking for some kind of legal afterwards. Hell yeah, make sure. I'm sure you already are, but if you aren't, make sure you're keeping, like, very detailed documentation and records of everything. The more records you keep, the easier it is for your legal team to move forward with anything if that's necessary. Try the hospital here. They're saying the left eye looks fine and they don't understand what's wrong with it. Oh, Godpac, like the reverse stink face, rubbing his cheeks on the back of Madman's head. Bet scared channel points don't make no channel points. You got less than a minute, folks. Get him in. They're like world renowned. Fun, really cool thing about being in New England and specifically like even close to Massachusetts is how good Massachusetts medical is in general. Like, even the worst of the Massachusetts hospitals are better than a lot of the best hospitals in other states, which is crazy. So, being as hypochondriatic as I am, even if I'm at, like, a rough hospital, I know that I'm still probably going to get a really high-quality care. So, it's very comforting when I am, like, in the thick of, like, a hypochondriatic panic attack to know that, hey, if something goes wrong, I got the best chance on the planet of getting through it here. Grapple here, Madman taking it to Godpac a little bit. Godpac had the early advantage. Madman coming back with some momentum. He grabbed him by the horns! Did you see that?
I don't know if that was like my eyes playing tricks on me or an actual animation, but it looked like Madman grabbed Godpog by the horns and threw him right in. And yeah, keeping records of all the crap, I'm gonna ask them at the next appointment if they think laser eye surgery will fix it. Yeah, here's hoping. Oh wow, punched him right in the dick. Try to save up for LASIK from them. It's just hard to know when we'll have enough for a house nowadays. True. Big right hands, Talthar. You saw him get up on the apron to remove that turnbuckle. I'm hoping my realtor gets back to me with some good news. So, update on the housing thing. And obviously, like, there's a very small percentage chance that this does end up being good news. But I've got hope for this one. So, literally a month ago, like, I think exactly 30 days ago today, there was a house that went up in the local market. It's like 600 square feet with, it's got a basement, a big yard, a garage. Beautiful house, but it's a one bedroom. So when we asked about it a month ago, oh, Godpock, look at this. Up on the shoulders. Oh my God, brutal by Godpocalypse. Dropping Madman right on his neck too. That's the first time we've seen Godpock use that move when he picks up a win with it. Godpock, do you got a name for that? That has to be a move thief. You beat him with the move thief? Godpock. Beating Madman with his own move. I don't even know what to call it. Holy cow. Well, here is your winner of the match and advancing in the EPW Intercontinental Championship Tournament. The Nightmare. Godpocalypse. Yeah, I'm you, but stronger. Oh my goodness. What a match. Big win from Godpocalypse. And what is it called? The day has been a chalk so far. Is that the saying? Because the overs have been winning thoroughly today. As Godpock goes to 3-2 on a 2-win streak in singles action, Madman is 1-3, and his win streak comes to an end. He starts a loss streak. Oh, fuck. I gotta go and... I did the tag records for the women's match earlier, but not the... like, the individual tag. So we got Sister Kara and Yokai. They had to take a loss in tag. And then Valerie Venom. And Destruction Doll. Picked up wins. Destruction Doll was on a 3-loss streak in tag before that. Her first win in tag in quite a bit. Coming up next, debut tag team match, my friends. As we've got... oh, fuck. Oh, wait, we did make them as a tag team, didn't we? Let me do Duncan first, just to see. Duncan McGregor. Yeah, Chaotic, let's go. And they are taking on the Milkman. And BB Purple Man. Oh shit, did the gingers give me... they did. Okay, we got entrance music for the gingers. I'm gonna get predictions up really quick. Debut tag match. Burly Gingers debut. Taking on Chalky Milk. 0-1. 5 minutes around the clock. Live to win, till you die, till the light dies in your eyes. The following contest is a debut base tag match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making their Enclave Pro Wrestling tag team debut, the team of Duncan McGregor and Chaotic. The Burly Gingers! Aside of the women's tag, this has been a very uncompetitive flux. Yeah! That's true! Goblins like chunky redheads, noted for science. I mean, who doesn't like chunky redheads? Let's be honest. Chunky is hunky. I love that. That's such a good, like, just in general body positivity thing to say. I love that. And their opponents making their way to the ring at a combined weight of 1,069 pounds, the Milkman, Pee Pee Poo Poo Man, Chocolate Milk! Is it D&D? Is it D&D 5e official? All goblins want to fuck redheaded dwarves. It is! Oh, no shit. Is it? I suppose Chaotic would be Hunk and Duncan would be Hunky and Chunky. I love that. Y'all like Chunky Redheads? We love you? We do love you, Infinite. Their entrance song was from South Park? The Burly Gingers? It was the grinding montage song? No way! Holy shit. Imagine not loving Infinite. I know, right? Like, even with the questionability of the memes that Infinite sends to people, we still love him very much. It was a joke. That's more of a goblins with a fat ass lore. Hell yeah. Fat ass goblin was actually my nickname in high school. Fat ass goblin, these nuts. Oh, got him. I am not some sediment that will just casually settle at the bottom. I demand the very top. What is happening? Why is there litigation going on between... Is this Salty Pete in character without bar? What is happening? I'm lost. Lurk for the meeting. Enjoy the lurk is Duncan McGregor. Stomping away at the Milkman. Duncan, he's used to that goat's milk, not raccoon milk. Raccoon milk is a rarity across the pond. As the Milkman gets out of there, throws him into the corner, and now Chaotic's trying to get some. Milkman says no. We gotta play Goblins with Fat Asses soon. Wait, is that an actual... That's the name of a game? I had no idea. Bets, bets, bets. There's a minute left. Get them bets in there. People are scared of the bets, King Cygnus, because the over has won every single match today. So people see the over and it's like, oh, well, man, I mean, I'll put in some on the under just to make it more interesting in this matchup. Chocolate milk, or rather the Milkman himself. I'll match the 110 that's already on here. Make it an even 50-50 split. There we go. Or 52-48. Close enough. Got some bets in there. That was a little bit of a bigger payout. Pee Pee Pooper Man gets tagged in. Grabs Taltar. Picks him up. Walking him across. And drops him face first on that close turnbuckle. Close right. Southeast, we call it. Only bet against Burly Ginger, so Sig could win some scratch. Oh, man. Knee to the back of the head. The predictions. Oh, and more on the Burly Ginger. So... Firmly Burly Gingers are the overs right now. Pee Pee Poo Poo Man, though, stomping away. How good do Scotsmen handle their pee pee poo poo? That's the question. May I pitch a thing to you? I mean, sure. What are you going to pitch? A grenade, a baseball, a watermelon? Chaotic, what a running knee strike. Flipping Pee Pee Poo Poo Man inside out. Oh my god. Cutting through him like a poop knife. Stomping at the back of the head. Chaotic right now. Kicking Pee Pee Poo Poo Man right in the back. I gotta put my hair up. Oh my god, it keeps getting in my face. Jesus. I'm getting sweaty because it's getting hot in here. Everyone may DM and pitch whatever. All right, I'm gonna DM you right now, Ezzy. I'm gonna pitch something. Okay. I've never DM'd you before. I'm gonna pitch you something very goofy. Here you go. I think this is a pretty good pitch.
SPP Poopoo Man. Grapple here. Knees to the chest. Oh my god, several knees to the chest. Softening up PP Poopoo Man. One like a laxative and only getting a one. PP Poopoo Man throws him off. A banana ball? I've been watching Banana Ball on YouTube and that is so much fun. Banana Ball is so much better than regular baseball. Oh, we can't even see what's happening because of the Milkman. Milkman, get out of the way, bruv. Who thought this camera angle was a good idea for tag matches? That is a very good pitch. I love it. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Pee-pee Poopoo Man. Oh, what a Samoan drop! And Pee-pee Poopoo Man lands hard. He's flipped around, though. He's going to the wrong corner. Both guys are crawling around like little slugs. What is Pee-pee Poopoo Man doing? He doesn't know which way to go, but he makes the tag. Duncan and Milkman going at it. Milkman, what a diving clothesline. And he kips up into Chaotic. That's a great camera angle. Look at that ass. Hell yeah. Oh, Tora the trash can to Duncan McGregor. One. And a kick out at one. A Tora the trash can only got a one. Goofy Movie is so great. We were saying the other day, like, that there needs to be a cheese that tastes as good as any of the cheese in the Goofy Movie looks. Between, like, the canned cheese or the cheese on the pizza. Oh, another leaping lariat there by the Milkman. But we need some Goofy Movie cheese. Duncan has plus two pin escapes for days. He's got at least a couple of them. Standing shooting star by the Milkman. What? If there was ever a mixed tag challenge. I call you, and we come out to Powerline. I mean, the mixed tag challenge, would be Toaster and Goblin Queen, no? Oh, going up top. Cokes. Duncan. Oh, dropping face first. Oh, goodness. In the corner. Where is the Pee-Pee Poopoo Man going? He's sliding. He's going down underneath. 2K? You wanna not 2K on us this morning? What the fuck is happening? Well, there's a neck breaker from Duncan, but I have no idea what just happened. Sorry. I was beside myself with bewilderment as to what just happened. As Duncan goes over, makes the tag to Chaotic. Pee-pee Poopoo Man, maybe he got hit on his head too hard or something earlier in this matchup. He grabs Chaotic, kicks him right in the dick, and drops him with a DDT, but hurts his back. Pee-pee Poopoo Man has a hurt back in this matchup. Where's he going? Goes right over Chaotic, hits the pump kick, but Pee-pee Poopoo Man just takes it. Chaotic from behind, looking for the Chaos Embrace. Pee-pee Poopoo Man catches him. Kick to the midsection, another DDT, drops him down. Sister Yokai, thank you for the lurk. Going for the pin. One, and a kick out at one. 2K hates quarter moves. 2K hates us, really. Chaotic. Oh my god, look at him bringing the Pee-Pee Poopoo Man to the mat and palm thrusting it. That's what we call a fucking... Oh shit, what do we call that? I remember. Elbow to the face. A waffle stomp. There we go. He was waffle stomping Pee-Pee Poopoo Man right there. Right down the drain. Chaotic. Oh, what is this? The Maelstrom. The three chaotic Germans become one giant Maelstrom here. Boom. Oh my goodness. That might be enough to do it. Pee-Pee Poopoo Man, his back was already hurting him. In comes the Milkman and breaks it up before a count of one. I just want to see her tag finisher one time. Well, that's too damn bad. What do you think is worse in 2K, corner moves or submissions? Yes. A punt to the face. Oh my god, Pee-Pee Poopoo Man kicked out of the punt. I thought it was over because Milkman already broke up a pin. Oh my god, stomps at the face. Pee-Pee Poopoo Man, he gets hit with the pump kick. Oh my god, Duncan McGregor gets tagged in. Why was his arm just like that? I think he might actually have brain damage. That's something you see in brain damage patients. Like, they'll freeze up, their joints will lock up. I think Pee-Pee Poopoo Man may have actually suffered a concussion from that kick. And Milkman is getting beat up now. Oh my goodness. Milkman goes down, Duncan McGregor coming into the corner. Pee-Pee Poopoo Man gets the foot up. Grabs him.
Pee-pee Pooper Man has Duncan McGregor up on his shoulder. Where's he going? Stun gun. Yoink. Pee-pee Pooper Man trying to go make a tag here to the Milkman. He does. Waffle Stomp is when you take a shit in the shower. You gotta use your... Yeah, that's what I meant. Yeah. He had Pee-pee Pooper Man on the ground. He was hitting him with the palm thrust, so... He's trying to stomp him down the drain, baby. That's the old Waffle Stomp. Duncan makes a tag. Milkman, oh my god, went for the shot block or something. On to Chaotic. Oh, Chaotic gets the elbows to the gut here. To the Milkman. Collar and elbow tie up. Irish whips him into his own partner, though. Ducks down underneath. Milkman comes on back, gets pumped up. Oh my god, it kicked in the back of the head, but the Milkman kips up. Milkman and Chaotic collar and elbow tie up. Chaotic looking for a suplex, and oh my god, knees him right in the face. Chaotic grabbing the arms of the Milkman, not allowing him to even remember where he is after that move. Looking for a hammerlock afterwards. Milkman's got nowhere to go, and Chaotic is absolutely picking him apart right now. Rich? Oh, okay, person in the crowd. This is a live mic, buddy. You better calm down back there. We'll have security escort you out. Chaotic again, working the opposite side. I like cheese in the background. What a sign. Soft reset time. I'm already zoinked. I can't do any more soft resets. But if you need a soft reset, be it water, a cup of coffee, a cup of tea, maybe a snack, bag of chippies or something like that, maybe some meditation or some breathing exercises, get that in there. Take a self-check, mental self-check. How are you feeling? Are you hungry? Are you thirsty? Tag is made to Duncan McGregor as the Milkman is struggling to his feet. Oh, gets hit with a pump kick. Milkman playing possum there. He's a trash panda. But his uncle is a possum. There's a right hand from the Milkman. Goes over, makes a tag to Pee Pee Poo Poo Man. 4PM comes into the ring, squares up with Duncan. Two big boys! Oh my god, what a huge headbutt. The battering ram, but gets kicked in the face by Milkman. The Glasgow Kiss. What is this? Duncan gut wrench. Sit out power bomb. 1, 2. Oh, Pee Pee Poo Poo Man kicks out again. How? How is he kicking out of all of this? I thought that match was over. Duncan McGregor goes over, tags up to Chaotic, but Pee Pee Poo Poo Man operating entirely on instinct right now. Chaotic grabbing Pee Pee Poo Poo Man, kicking him in the face. And then a forearm to the side of the head. Going for a pin after that one. That might be enough to do it. 1, 2, 3. And it took one last flurry of blows, but here are your winners. Successful in their Enclave Pro Wrestling Tag Team debut. The team of the Iron Brute Duncan McGregor and the Chaos Warrior Chaotic, the Burly Gingers.
Burly Gingers winning their debut. They go to 1-0, baby.
And then Chalky Milk falls to 0-2. They're on a 2-loss streak. Okay, Harry, you're really stressing me. Can we come on over here? The winners, Chaotic and Duncan. So Chaotic in tag goes to 2-1. 2-win streak for him. Duncan in tag is 2-0 in tag. We got Pee Pee Pooper Man and the Milkman. So Milkman is first, 0-3 in tag. Oh, I guess they're 0-3 even. Yeah, 0-3. Alright, coming up next, Judge Soulbane taking on Broken Trey in an MMA cage match. Broken Trey, of course, the jobber of the Enclave, trying to throw hands with the World Heavyweight Champion, Coakley. Coakley's like, nah, you know what? If you even want to have me listen to your voicemail, you first gotta go through the judge, jury, and executioner of the Enclave.
Star Predictions. MMA Cage. Broken Trey, who's 1-5. The following contest is an MMA cage match scheduled for one fall. The only way to win this match is by submission or knockout. Introducing first, making his way to the ring. From Cleveland, Ohio, he is the CEO of Broken Pro Wrestling and the jobber of the Enclave, Broken Trey! 5 minutes on the clock, predictions are up. Is this for the title? No, this is not for the title. Gotta change their victory motion. Oh, you don't think that was a good victory motion for them? Jobber title is only defended at PLE? Correct, only at PLEs. You are stuck with the jobber title for a full pay-per-view cycle. Also, folks who may not know the terminology PLE, PPV, PLE stands for Premium Live Event. It's a more modern term for what used to be called pay-per-views in wrestling. And the term is a little bit of a misnomer because, like, especially around here, you don't have to pay to watch a pay-per-view, but that's what the big blow-off shows each month or cycle were referred to as. Oh, fuck, hold on. Oh, I don't have Judge Silbane music. Okay, cool. And his opponent, making his way to the ring from Fort Wayne, Indiana, by way of Integral, he is the judge, jury, and executioner of the Enclave. Judge Soulbane. I'm gonna turn on the air conditioning really quick because it's getting hot quickly. Looked a little feminine for Duncan. Yeah, we didn't actually change the victory animation, I don't think. So it is whatever the generic one is. Didn't even think about that. That's always one that sneaks through the cracks there. Broken Trey coming out strong with a right hand to Judge. Goes for a back suplex in the middle of the ring and connects with it. Goes for a kick on a Judge Silbane. Hold on. Get your bets in there. 2 minutes on the bets, folks. 2 minutes on the bets. Oh, whew. Holy cow. I had a heart attack for a minute. Hold on. Holy cow. Woo! Oh, man. That was rough. I am okay. Yeah. Oh, man. So I checked my email because I was waiting to see if my realtor had gotten back to me. And my therapist emailed me with the Google Meet link. And, I was like, we rescheduled. Like, we're supposed to do this tomorrow. And then there was a reply immediately from that email that was an updated invitation for tomorrow at 2, which is when we rescheduled to. But I was like, am I supposed to be in therapy right now? Or, like, was I supposed to be in therapy at 10? Did I just no-call, no-show my therapy session? but no. Whoo!
That caught me really off guard. Woohoo, man. I just gotta check it several more times to make sure that, yeah, this is in fact tomorrow. But yeah, it is. Okay. Woo. My goodness. Okay. Yeah, that gasp was a completely involuntary. That was 100% a panic gasp. I was so scared. Oh my god. Holy cow, what a kick to the hamstring from Broken Trey onto Judge Soulbane. Oh, wow, okay, person in the crowd. Broken Trey coming alive right now with some punches to the face. Again, the only way to win this match is knockout or submission. Broken Trey going on over to the corner. Oh my god, what a knee right to the face of Judge Soulbane. Gut wrench here by Broken Trey. Suplex. But oh my god, Judge Soulbane gets right up and hits a huge spine buster. Oh my god, almost like an Alabama slam. Man, so much force. Now he's choking the life out of Broken Trey. Why is there an LED screen here? Wrenching at the arm is Judge Soulbane. Broken Trey gets up, hits the right hand. Judge Soulbane, here we go. He's got a Fujiwara armbar locked in. Broken Trey's got nowhere to go. They're out of rope breaks. Oh, this is MMA, remember. Trey gets a counter with a knee right into the shoulder area. But again, Judge Soulbane fighting right out of it. Judge Soulbane grabs Trey by the back of his head, walks him over the corner, slams him face first into the turnbuckle. Judge Soulbane hits him with a stiff right, a grapple. Oh, wow, what a clothesline coming out of the corner from Judge Soulbane. And look at this. Judge Soulbane is getting all worked up right now. Goes to stop. Broken Trey gets up. Oh, Judge Soulbane missed his kick. Trey double arm choke toss to Judge Soulbane. Judge may have given up his momentum. Yeah, very errant kick there. We're going to chalk that one up as an error in the stat column. And Broken Trey showboating to the crowd a little bit. Being like, I'm not locked in here with you. You're locked in here with me, brother. Again, grabbing him by the... Oh, no, grabbing him by the head. Slamming Judge Soulbane. Head first into the canvas, but Judge Soulbane again gets up. Collar and elbow tie, but Trey wins this one. Brings Judge Soulbane all the way across the ring, and Soulbane fights out of it. Soulbane gets the elbows in there. Irish whips him. Across the ring, Judge Soulbane. What a power slam with authority. Judge Soulbane, what is this? Rolling through, oh my god. Like a monkey flip, just tossing Broken Trey with his foot across the arena. Or the ring, even. Judge Soulbane again, wilding out, and he's got an armbar locked in. But releases the hold, he's working on those arms. Soulbane, oh, gets caught by Broken Trey and just slapped in the face. Trey slapping the shit out of him. Irish whip into the ropes. Broken Trey waiting, hits a big back elbow. Stomp it away at Judge Soulbane, perhaps looking for a submission here. What is this? No, again, working that right arm. He knows that Judge Soulbane needs that arm to lock in his arm bar. Like, if he's only got strength in one arm, he's not going to be able to leave it locked in. Gives Trey more opportunities to break out of any submission. Broken Trey, what is this? What a punch! Another punch, walking Judge Soulbane across the ring. Soulbane reverses the Irish whip, but Trey hits a knee smash. And again, another taunt, standing tall over Judge Soulbane. Broken Trey picks Judge Soulbane up, could be looking for the broken ending here. No, an Anaconda Vice! Anaconda Vice is locked in. Will Judge Soulbane tap? He does not. He gets the elbows right to the shoulder, and look at the immediate welt that left on Broken Trey. Judge Soulbane grabs him by the back of the head, walks him over across the ring. Can he get there? He can. Judge Soulbane, what is this? Dragon screw. Oh my god, into some sort of leg lock submission here. Trey does not submit, and Judge Soulbane lets go with a hold and another arm bar. Judge Soulbane has yet to hit his signature arm bar. Oh, what is this? He's waiting for something, clearly. Oh, I don't know what he was setting up for there. Judge Soulbane. Oh, looking for Hell's Gate. Judge Soulbane locks in Hell's Gate onto Broken Trey. Trey's got nowhere to go. Trey, can he fight out of it? Judge Soulbane's got it locked in, but he releases the hold for some reason. Judge Soulbane jumping on over, getting into the corner. Trey is laid out in the middle of the ring. He didn't submit, but he is exhausted. Judge Soulbane, what is this? Going up to the top rope from up top. What a big splash from Judge Soulbane. Collapsing the rib cage of broken Trey. Picks him up, Judge Soulbane, here it is, the armbar. He's been working this arm all match, and that's it. Trey taps out immediately. Immediately. Here is your winner of the match via submission, Judge Soulbane. Very, very calculated play there by Judge Soulbane. Working the arm the entire match. Technically, like, for the mechanics of the game, he got knocked out, but we're gonna chalk it up in the win column to a submission, because Trey just tapped immediately. Judge had worked, softened up that arm all match, locked it in. Trey had no option but to tap out. Broken Trey goes to 1-6. 4-loss streak. Judge Soulbane goes to 3-3. He was on a 1-win streak. Coming up next, semi-main event, we got the debut of the Twitch president. Taking on the EPW Women's World Champion, the Goblin Queen. This is non-title, and it is a good old-fashioned singles match. This is non-title. I didn't check and see if there was music for the Twitch president. Hold on. Character creator. Yes, okay, there is. I could think of no better theme for the Twitch president. Oh my god. The following contest is a debut singles match scheduled for one fall with a 20-second ring out and a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, making their way to the ring, they are the president of Twitch, the Twitch president! Your Chadliness, Giga Chadliness. I think we figured out Judge Soulbane's territory, MMA-style match. Judge Soulbane is why we have the MMA-style match. That match stipulation became a match from his rivalry with Chaotic back in Season 2. But that came about as like the big blow-off to the feud that they were having. Submission and knockouts only. No pinfalls, no escape. Did I not hit? Oh, I didn't hit start prediction. Okay, cool. Thank you. I had already had them written up. There we go. Thank you, Sig. Thank you. And their opponent. Making her way to the ring. She is the Empress of Trash. The goddess of gremlins, the monarch of mayhem. She is both the Enclave Pro Wrestling Super Prestigious Dark Match and women's... Oh, new music? Fuck. Oh, Goblin Queen champ. Yes.
Who starts to cool story, but they never.
She is both the Enclave Pro Wrestling Super Prestigious Dark Match and Women's World Champion, the Goblin Queen, Jesse Always.
I love that song. I don't think there's many, if any, League of Legends songs that haven't been absolute bangers. Gabo, look at that wheelbarrow takedown right off the bat as I will smoke time. As this is, folks, it's our semi-main event as two of the championship matches got moved earlier in the card. This is the semi-main event. After this matchup, the main event, number one contendership for the EPW World Heavyweight Championship. Goliathus versus Jazzy. Going for a pin. One. Two count. Twitch President getting the two count on the Goblin Queen already. Double champ. Stomping away. It is absolutely an honor to have the Twitch President here as a member of the EPW roster, as a member of our community, of course. Make sure you show the utmost respect to the Twitch President. Gabo, though, showing a little bit less in respect as she slaps the Twitch President across the face. It's a drop kick. Oh, my God. Goblin Queen picking up Twitch President. Collar and elbow tie-up. Irish whip into the corner. Twitch President just hanging out. Gabo saying, welcome to EPW with a scoop slam down. Getting set up in the corner and going for a pin first. One. Oh, a kick out at one. Oh, my goodness. Twitch President fighting out. Really? I didn't know. Just started it. Yeah. Yeah. In season one, actually, some fun EPW like lore and backstory here. Judge Soulbane's character was kind of like a Kane type, a similar color scheme. He was like a hybrid Kane Undertaker, had a similar mask with the long hair and whatnot. And then we did a gimmick change for him in season two, where we turned him more into like his real life counterpart. So the Judge Soulbane we have looks a lot like Judge Soulbane in real life. And he is trained in Muay Thai, I believe. Traditional Muay Thai. So we made his fighting style more Muay Thai, like kicks and mat wrestling based. And that meshed really well with Chaotic in season two, who himself is like a striker and a technical grappler. And they had a series of great matches in season two that ended with the MMA cage. Oh, look at this. Gabo jumping on the back of the Twitch President, trying to rip that mask off their face. Oh, my goodness. This match is brought to you by some mobile game. A Raid Shadow Legends, who, while not sponsoring us right now, have sponsored us in the past. Also, we now have the life experience of knowing why so many people get sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends, and that's because holy fuck do they pay you. Holy shit. Our most, like, lucrative sponsorship to date was Raid Shadow Legends. And it wasn't even our most participated in, sponsorship that we did, which is wild. So yeah, when you see your favorite YouTuber or Twitch streamer, whoever, be it shilling Raid Shadow Legends for a week or so, know that that person probably got paid, like, five figures to do it. Wow, the miss to the face from Twitch President and the referee not calling for the bell, too. Gabo kicking out. She probably drinks that mist as like a protein shake for breakfast, so it's not super effective on him. But wow, referee just completely... Oh, the fucking terms of service, I think that was. Holy shit, one, two. Oh, but Gabo kicks out of the TOS. Holy shit. I thought that was it. I thought that the Twitch President was going to pin the EPW Women's World Champion in their debut. Not many people kick out of the terms of service. Springboard, what is it? Stunner! Oh my God, off the middle rope. What is happening right now? I have no idea what's going on. It's a judge specialty match because IRL, he does some form of MMA. I forget, I want to say judo, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, it's Muay Thai you're thinking of. Hell yeah. I didn't agree to those! Oh my god. That makes sense. You can't be held into them if you didn't agree to them. Flapjack out of the corner and a kip up. Going for a pin here. Referee wasn't expecting it. Will that be enough? One, two for the upset. And Gabo still kicks out. Holy cow. Unbelievable. Literally the heart of a champion here. Which president seems to be a bit of a heel, eh? Grabs Gabo by the back. Oh man, going after the tricep and saying goodbye, you're banned. Gabo kips up though. Twitch President seems to have the Goblin Queen's number, and there's another terms of service. This one, not a permanent ban, just a temp ban. Will that be enough? Oh, Gabo gets out of the way. High kick, low kick, a grapple, the Goblin Queen. Suplex, oh, face buster, oh my God. Goblin Queen hitting the ropes. What is this? Leaping. Goes for a splash and the Twitch President gets out of the way. But misses the clothesline. Goblin Queen. Irish Whip gets reversed. Twitch President. What are they on right now? Twitch President doing some taunting in front of the front row. I mean, they're getting their money's worth. Also, for those of you that play League of Legends and are familiar, which member of the Heartsteel boy band, specifically like in their Heartsteel skin, is your favorite? In order for me, it's Set, maybe a tie, maybe Ezreal first, but Set, Ezreal, and Cassante are the top three. Everybody else is way low. Cade and Kane, I found the Edgelords. Oh, what is this? Twitch President. It's Twitch President looking for the third TOS. It's three strikes, and you're out. TOS connects. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Here is your winner of the match. The Twitch President. The Twitch President wins their debut match against the Goblin Queen, as he always. Oh my goodness. The double champion has been defeated, and her three-win streak has come to an end at the hands of the Twitch President. Oh my goodness, what does this mean? Goblin Queen's gonna have so much promo material for this week. Oh my goodness. First, Aurora steals her belt. Then the Twitch President comes in and permabans her. It's for the penis command, probably. But folks, the next match, this is our main event of the evening. Or morning, whatever time it is. Let me make sure I didn't actually accidentally skip over any matches. No, yeah, this is it. And we're going to spice it up. Do we not have just a regular 2 out of 3 falls match? Hello? All right. Well, we'll edit this match to suit our needs. But this is going to be a 2 out of 3 falls match. Custom match rules. 2 out of 3 falls on. KO off. DQ on. Ring out 20. Rope break is on. False count anywhere is off. Time limit, no limit. Entrance run-ins off. Mid-match and post are fine. We'll edit some of these just in case somebody ends up getting DQ'd. Predictions up. Twitch President won their debut.
Looking to upgrade?
Bully's 3-1. Grazi is 18-1.
The following contest is our main event of the evening and is a 2 out of 3 falls match scheduled for...
Why the fuck is it scheduled for one fall?
It's a 2 out of 3 falls match. The winner will be declared the number one contender for the Enclave Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, making his way to the ring, from Long Island, New York, by way of the Isle of Kings, he is accompanied by Talthar of Talthar, Talthar, and Talthar, the Captain Goliathist!
How can Jazzy go for World Heavyweight Championship while holding on to the Intercontinental Championship? Please explain. If he wins this match, he'll be the number one contender. That's up. Also, to be clear, if he were to win the Intercontinental Championship, if he were to win the World Heavyweight Championship, he would have to vacate the Intercontinental. This has happened before. Infinite was the Intercontinental Champion. He had won the number one contendership for the World Heavyweight Championship and won that belt. And then he had to vacate the Intercontinental Championship. So if Jazzy were to win the World Heavyweight strap, he would have to vacate the Intercontinental. You can't hold both of those belts at the same time. Mr. Three People hold all 5 belts? I'm okay with that. I'm okay with 3 people holding all 5 belts. It's happened before in pro wrestling. Sometimes the storylines lead to that destination. I am a fucking superstar. I'm just asking what. Oh, I know. I thought I was just answering the questions. Yeah.
I am a superstar.
Like, look at TNA when Bobby Lashley held all the belts, baby. We don't got that going on, at least.
Church of Chaos. Time to
win. Oh, but fuck, I didn't even give Jazzy his entrance.
And his opponent, making his way to the ring. From Pandora's Box, he is the Destroyer of Factions. The face of Slight Pandemonium. The God of the Church of Chaos. He is everywhere, and he is the Enclave Pro Wrestling Intercontinental Champion. He is Jazzy!
I mean, Evolution held all the titles in the men's division for Raw. If people would like to get one of those belts off of those 3 people, the strap card can be located in the Channel Points Redemption menu. That's also true. And also, like, we got the Wheel of Chaos this month. Coakley just defended his World Heavyweight strap. Grapple here. I almost said King Sickness. Goalie on Jazzy. He's got him on the ropes literally right now. Get some wrapped up. Oh, a couple of knees to the face from Jazzy. Bicycle knees. Jazzy coming off his first loss all season. And about to get booted out of the ring right into Mason. What? The church is causing, I don't deserve a belt yet, so I will pass. And see, I don't agree with that. You got like the second most wins in all of EPW SIG. But you also just had a title match at the pay-per-view. Kick to the midsection, goalie. What is this? Oh man, swinging neckbreaker. I mean, who judges someone's deserves a belt? I think you would have a hell of a chance. Yeah, I think few people deserve a belt by various metrics more than you, Sig. But you did just have a match. You did the whole tournament scene. I said what I said. My story is not ready. Exactly. Your story is not yet written. Some people's stories right now are currently written, and we got to get through those stories. The question is, am I going to ADHD and start playing a ninja instead of a paladin? Lamenti, something that I think that I didn't want to voice because I didn't want to, like, pressure the way that you play Final Fantasy. Because I think it's beautiful how people experience Final Fantasy for the first time. Play is the way that you want. But if you want to be, like, efficient, I guess, at gaining levels, like, once you get into an expansion, if you're already, like, a little bit over-leveled for that expansion, go to a new class so you can learn the new class, see what it's like, and also, not waste, quote-unquote, the experience for the MSQ. Oh man, nice springboard moonsault there from Jaws the Unagoli. I have a feeling my first champion will probably be tag team champion. Ooh. And who would you be tagging with in this question, QLG? I genuinely don't want a belt. I want to find people... I want to find purpose outside of chasing a belt. That is totally valid, homie. That's the only way this stays fun for me long term. Sure. Oh, he missed the rolling kick! The rolling kick that has put so many away. Goalie evading it. Holy cow. Mr. Parr, welcome on in today. How are you doing, homie? Thank you for hitting that follow button. You caught us just in time for our main event this morning of EPW Flux. This is normally a Tuesday evening show, but we had some scheduling conflicts this week, so it is on Wednesday morning. But normally Tuesdays, and we also have Saturday morning cartoons on Saturdays, which is scheduled for this week. But other than wrestling, we do a variety of games, like NCAA College Football, Honkai Star Rail, Final Fantasy XIV Online, a number of things with a community focus on reducing the stigma surrounding mental health. We're very mental health forward, talk about it a lot. But whether you lurk, you're active, or otherwise, we appreciate you and hope you enjoy your stay, homie. Kind of getting over not having a belt. I'm better than a year ago, I'll say that. You absolutely are, Eagles, and we're very, very proud of your progress. You've been doing a great job, homie. The toaster's only purpose is to fight? Hell yeah. Probably Panda or Oni? Nice. The panda and the skill tree. Pandas tend to climb trees and then fall out of them. Look at Draco Malfoy in the front row right here. We're gonna take control of this. Look at this. He's all by himself with his like clone. What the hell? Jazzy boots goalie right in the face. Remember, this is 2 out of 3 falls. So the first fall will not do it. You gotta pin your opponent twice. Or submit. Or get disqualified, etc., etc. Toaster wouldn't know what to do with a fancy bell. Probably post it, if I had to guess. Jazzy with the shimmy. Saying praise the Church of Chaos. Here's a pinning attempt. And Mason Wolf is taking that opportunity while the ref is distracted to remove the turnbuckle pad. And that allows Jazzy to get a couple of cheap shots in on the goalie's face. Jazzy, what is this? Kinshasa to Goliathus. Goalie getting laid out and Jazzy looking for a falling rock. Referee getting into position. Kicks him in second, but goalie catches him. Goalie! Dr. Krabby!
He ain't
oh
one
my
year with the most
goodness.
Handsome streamer
on
Twitch.
I love you so much, Krabby. 1 year. Oh my goodness. Thank you so much for 1 year, Krabby. How are you doing? How are you feeling, Krabby? How are you feeling? Been thinking about you. We were just saying earlier today and yesterday, actually. We want to send you the well wishes, my friend. Hope you get back to 100% as soon as possible. And, I mean, unless you're looking in the mirror, the most handsome streamer on Twitch is you. You're the best abs in the business for a reason, Krabby. But how are you, my friend? Happy Wednesday. How's the week been treating you? Everybody, hold on. We got the Frosty Tool shout-out, but also the regular shout-out. Ain't nobody doing better than Dr. Krabby on Twitch. Like, legitimately. Dr. Krabby, the charming, the beautiful, the sexy French-Canadian Pokemon doc, who's all about love, laughs, and the crab fam. From cozy, soothing Sundays to charity streams and pride celebrations, he's a master of mixing retro games with Poke-Rogue adventures. Whether it's a sick stream or a heartfelt fundraiser, you're guaranteed hugs and a good time. Plus, he's got a soft spot for puzzles and a shiny new computer. Hashtag love wins, hashtag community vibes. Now, we were saying earlier, there is literally no reason to not follow somebody on Twitch. It's free, well, I mean,
obviously if somebody's a dickhead, but Dr. Krabby is like the opposite of a dickhead. He is the most beautiful, humble, helpful, heartwarming, love-filled individual on the platform. I take a lot of inspiration for Dr. Krabby for what we do around here. Try to emulate just everything about how wonderful he is to the best of our ability. Oh, there's that rolling kick. Jawsy hits goalie with it, and Talthar distracting the ref. This is a manager fest for sure. And Cookie missed it. Cutting blackouts goalie.
I mean, it happens. It happens.
But here's the pin. Will it be enough? Goalie kicks out at one of the rolling kick. I don't know what to feel about the tournament because I feel like I'm going to be out in the second round like the 76ers. I mean, that's fair. That's probably true because you are from Philadelphia and that's what happens to Philadelphia in the postseason. Oh, what an enziguri to the face from goalie. Jawsy just caught a Hurricanrana from the top rope and turned it into a pyro. He caught a Dragonrana from the top rope, in fact. Goalie was looking for the Dragonrana. It's one of his signatures. Jawsy caught it and put him right on his back. I did catch that one. Krabby distracted the commentator so much. I mean, have you seen Dr. Krabby? How could you not be distracted when he shows up in chat? I mean, my goodness. Oh, Talthar, what is this? He put his hands on Jawsy. How is that not a DQ? Oh my god, Mason Wolf distracting goalie, but Talthar literally put his hands on Jawsy and then immediately sends him out of the ring. Jawsy on the outside, referee gonna start counting some more, and goalie's doing some shimmies, saying he's got ice in his veins, baby. Cold-blooded. Jawsy gets to his feet. Goalie, what's he looking for here? Maybe looking for a senton of some kind, a tope. Goalie grabs Jawsy by the back of the head, walks him over, oh. Goalie could be looking for a high-risk maneuver. He is. He sets Jawsy up on the top rope. Punches him right in the head. Jawsy rolling through. Oh, God, no. Up to the top rope. Goalie! All the way up top. Superplex rolls through. What a neck breaker. Goalie for the first fall. One, two, and Jawsy kicks out. This is 2 out of 3 falls, and we haven't even had the first fall yet. Oh my god. Goalie, what is this now? Goalie, what is he looking for? Cyclone kick, but Jawsy gets out of the way. Jawsy, what a shotgun drop kick. Holy cow, these two, this is like a pay-per-view main event. Goalie with the face breaker knee smash, but Jawsy rolls out of the way. And Jawsy undoing the turnbuckle right in front of the referee. Goalie punches him in the face for it. Two punches, and the third punch takes him down. Mason Wolf gets up on the apron. What is even happening? Goalie comes to the outside. Jawsy misses a double axe handle. Goalie with the stick sniffer over the top. Oh, my God. I mean, this match, easily a match of the month candidate, right? Holy cow. June has only just begun, but this is easily a match of the month, and then obviously a match of the year candidate. Holy goodness. Goalie hammerlock here. Gonna be wrenching at the wrist of Jawsy now. Man, this is easily... Jawsy's had 19 matches. And this is easily one of the best that he's been in of all 19 matches. Same goes for goalie. Count of 8 as goalie grabs Jawsy. Sends him into the steel ring post. Bounces him head first. Whew. Count of 10. And goalie resets the count. Mason Wolf's getting yelled at by the front row. Oh my god, what a knee to the mouth and goalie. Oh my god, gets his lip busted open. Maybe saw a tooth go flying there. Jawsy grabs goalie, sends him into Mason Wolf. Mason Wolf's like, hey man, I don't want none of that. And Jawsy throws up the birds. I know I'm not supposed to talk bad about myself, but like, I don't see my lasting long in the tournament. I mean, I don't know. Like, look at what Yokai just did in the women's division earlier, Eagles. Oh, knee to the midsection. And Jawsy goes for a slap. Goalie fighting back. Another slap. We got an exchange of blows right here. Jawsy with a chop. Goalie's like, hit me with another one. Jawsy punches him right in the mouth. Goalie slaps Jawsy in the face. Eagles, hell yeah. Thank you, Infinite. Oh my god, exchanging blows. Hell yeah, who doesn't love exchanging a good blow now and then? Talthar trying to grab Jawsy's legs, but he's unable to. But he does distract him. Talthar distracted Jawsy while goalie is stunned. Oh my goodness.
The ref, I can't believe neither one of these managers has been ejected yet. Holy cow. Chelsea going over. Grabs goalie. Unprotected knee to the face. That's a Kami Goye. And goalie trying to get up in the corner. Jozzy letting him. Oh my goodness. How has there not been a single pinfall yet? Jozzy grabbing goalie. What is this? Jozzy. Oh my god! What was that? He killed that man. Goalie with the surprise roll up. This is how PJ just won the TV title. 1-2. And Jozzy kicks out in 2. Oh my god. Holy cow, imagine if 2 surprise roll-ups in a row would have pinned Jozzy. He gets up, a goalie's waiting for him. Couple of knees to the chest now. Oh man, Jozzy falls down hard. Goalie picking him up. Could be looking for a holy goalie. No, instead, grabs him. Irish whip into the ropes. Jozzy comes back, a tour of the island! Tour of the island to Jozzy! Going for the pin, can Jozzy touch the ropes? 1-2! He cannot, goalie gets the first fall off the tour! Or excuse me, goalie. Goalie gets the first fall. Jozzy got pinned. My brain moves faster than my mouth sometimes. That's the ADHD. Wrench of the arms here is goalie. Look at this. Double knees to the back. My goodness. Goalie. Oh, man. Jozzy hadn't suffered a pinfall in singles competition at all for months. And in the past 2 shows, he suffered 2 pinfalls back-to-back without getting a pin of his own. Double knees from goalie. Goalie stomping away at Jozzy. Boot right to the face. Mason Wolf, you gotta grab his legs, buddy. You gotta do what Talthar is doing. Goalie again. Walk it. Jozzy, maybe the power of the jar is run out. Who's to say what's going on here? Goalie grabbing the legs of Jozzy now. Jozzy. Working on the hamstrings. Goalie's getting pumped up, but Jozzy's going to the corner, getting to his feet. And here is Mason Wolf. He went to go talk to goalie. Goalie's trying to choke Jozzy out here. Oh, it goes for the knees, but Jozzy gets out of the way. And there's a surprise roll up, but he doesn't pin him. Interesting. Irish whip. Goalie goes into the ropes. Comes on back. There's the moonsault press slam. Jozzy going for the pin. 1-2-3. We're all tied up. 1-1. 1-1. Jozzy picking goalie up. He's looking for the falling rock. No. What is this? What is this move from Jozzy? I don't even know what that was. I don't even know what that was, but Jozzy with the pin. 1-2-3. In a match of the year candidate, here is your winner and new number one contender for the Enclave Pro Wrestling World Heavyweight Championship, Jozzy! Well, that's immediately going into the match of the year candidates right there. Holy cow. Manage a prediction. And this is the first underdog win of the day. And it was the main event. Goalie goes to 3-2. His streak comes to an end. Jozzy starts a new one. He goes to 19-1. He's going to be the first person this season to 20. And the only person that's even close is King Cygnus. The only person with double-digit wins aside from Jozzy is King Cygnus. King Cygnus has 13. Jozzy has 19. Who? Does anybody even have close to 10? Let's do a sort Z to A. PJ Majin has... So here are the top 3... win totals in EPW right now. Jozzy with 19, King Cygnus with 13, PJ Majin with 9, and then Chaotic and Coakley are tied for 6. It is not even close between the top 2 and everybody else. Holy cow. Wow. Wow. All right, match of the year. So we're in June now. We got 06-05-2024.
Looking to upgrade.
Jazzy versus Goalie. EPW number one. Contendership. World Heavyweight Championship. Well, my friends, as much as I really would like to stay on stream tonight, unfortunately, I do gotta call it today. It is normally my therapy day, and we will be back tomorrow morning. I don't have therapy until 2 in the afternoon, so we'll be A-okay for normal stream tomorrow morning. Tomorrow will probably be NCAA football with something else, maybe Final Fantasy or whatnot. But as always, my friends, remember that even if it doesn't feel like it, even if you're struggling today, you are worth it. You're doing a good job. Just because it doesn't feel like you're making progress right now doesn't mean you're not making progress. Week, 2 weeks, a year down the road, you'll look back to now and be like, I came far. I came far. Now, if you look back to where you were a year ago, you'll say, hey, I've come far. And for that, I am proud of all of you. I love y'all. Let's find somebody to go raid out into, because I don't actually know who we're going into yet. Let's see who's live. Who of the homies is live right now? Or maybe a new friend. Depends on what it's looking like. It is a Wednesday, and we're not normally live on a Wednesday. There are also not many people live on a Wednesday. Hell of a way to end it. No kidding. If anybody has a suggestion for a raid, because there are scarcely few people on right now. Raid my bedroom, I will, Dr. Krabby, any day. I'll go for a panty raid at your house. Hey there, Shannon. MKO homemade designs. This is so many. MKO homemade designs. Okay, let's see. And then Loki the God. This is not so many. It's three. Content warning. We got Crash Team Racing. Loki the God is playing. They're not even online. I'm not gonna raid somebody who is not online. The Ginger Buddha. Gotta lurk, but don't feel obligated to pick any of mine. Just throwing them out there. I mean, you're the only person who threw out people that are online, so I don't see why not. No, I'll tell you what, Dr. Krabby's in here. Is there anybody from Heart and Soul that is live right now? There is indeed. Great channel. That's where we're gonna go. This is the new friend. We've never been. Is this pronounced Josta, Yasta, Hasta? How is that J pronounced? We have not been introduced, so this is gonna be our first time meeting. Yeah, get that raid in there. Thank you all, everybody, again, for hanging out today on this unusual off-schedule day, since we normally take the good old Wednesdays off. But you are all loved and appreciated and wonderful human beings. And again, we'll be back tomorrow morning, maybe with some NCAA, maybe with some Final Fantasy, some Honkai Star Rail. We'll see. It's going to be a nice variety Thursday. If I could fucking copy my own raid message, baby. Boom. All right. Take it easy, everybody. We'll be back here tomorrow.